Hello and welcome to the World Skateboarding Tour 2023 Rome Street. We are back in the ancient city of Rome for the second tour event of the season, seeing over 200 skateboarders from 30 different countries competing on this custom-built course for their spot on the podium and those all-important points on the road to Paris 2024 Olympics. Our last event was in San Juan, Argentina, but we have now arrived at the foot of the Colosseum to see the top eight finalists in both women's and men's battle it out in today's finals. I'm Mark Churchill, and I am super happy to say that my guest joining me in the booth for finals today is the one and only Manny Santiago.
Thanks for joining me. I'm excited. Usually I would be sad not to be skating today, but I am happy to be able to talk about my peers and talk about skateboarding.
Yeah, it sucks I'm not going to be calling your tricks today, but you're going to help me out a lot.
100%, 100%.
So I mentioned earlier we're on the road to the Paris 2024 Olympics, but that's not the only opportunity to get points so far. We've got five more events coming up in the earlier in the year we're in San Juan, we're now in Rome, then we take it to Lausanne, and we've got our World Championships of Park in Ostia, Italy, and Japan Street World Championships as well. That's going to be super exciting. So Manny, this is an amazing course we've got here.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. It's got everything you need. It's got rails, hubbas, gap to hubbas, double sets, square and round rails, Euro gaps. It literally, they were able to squeeze every single thing you need on a course. And it's right next to the Colosseum, so don't get no better than that.
It's crazy. That backdrop is, you know, it's so imposing. You've got the Colosseum there just shrouded in. We're here skateboarding. I never thought I'd do something like that.
Yeah, no, it's funny because I was walking on the way here earlier this morning. And I walked by a store and they have the gladiators that you could put on. And I had a quick thought. I'm like, it'd be so funny if someone came to in the gladiator and meant business. Like, what a highlight that would be, no?
So, speaking of our course, we caught up earlier with Chris Joslin to take a closer look.
Hi, my name is Chris Joslin. We're out here in Rome, Italy. We're going to take a look at this course, give you guys a little preview, and just give you guys all the information you need before you watch this contest. So on this side of the course, we have the quarter pipe that people are going to be using to turn around and go back the other way. And then here in the middle, we have the double set with the square rail. It looks small, but don't be fooled. It's a little intimidating. And on each side, we have a bump to bump with a rail to go across it. Little hubba, if you want to bump to the hubba, it's up to you. And as I said, it's the same on both sides, so whatever you see on that side, you're gonna see on that side. And so here's the main attraction, the gap to hubba, along with the long rails on the side that are somewhat kind of low, but very long, so that might work out better for some technical tricks. This hubba is gonna be intimidating for whatever you wanna do. It is pretty interesting with the gap in. It's not very short. You gotta hold your tricks for a little while, so anything you see go down on this takes skill. So all the tricks you see everyone doing on this is not easy, even though they make it look that way, but just know it's not. So it's kinda hard to pick one good thing about it when it's all really good, but I guess preferably, being that I like to jump downstairs, the gap right here in the center is going to be the main attraction. What I'm probably going to lean towards the most, or at least end my line off to have a little bit of a climactic ending. So this will probably be my favorite part about it. Thank you, World Skateboarding Rome, for having us out here again. Hope you guys enjoy the show.
Great to hear from Chris there, and unfortunately we won't be seeing him skate in the finals, but Manny, that shows just how hard that cut was, right?
Yeah, 100%. There was the very high level of skating every cut. leveled up this year, and especially on this course again, and the amount of tricks that are going down, the singles are now in their runs.
Yeah, that's something that you're seeing, the craziest tricks go down in runs. So let's take a look at our format for today. We got the 2-5-3 format, two runs, 45 seconds each. Follow anywhere on the course, counting scores, one from run and two from best tricks. Manny, how does that get the best out of the skaters, that format?
Well, it does, because, you know, skating is not just a one trick thing, and it's also not just a bunch of tricks squeezed in one. So what's cool about it is you have someone, for instance, who's, and then they have to think what they do in runs and do hard tricks as singles. And then you have someone that's like not good at runs, and they have to get better at runs than they can pick up in the single. So it's best for both parties. And if you're not a runs person, it makes you want to be a better run person, which will make you a better skater. And if you're not a singles person, well, that makes you want to get bangers, so then you can go film in the street. It makes you a better skater. So
it's also a little bit about strategy. Strategies are going to be moving forward into finals.
I think in finals, you're not going to see anybody hold back. We know what everybody's bringing to the table. And although they did really, really well, you know one or two tricks that they can upgrade, because as competitors, we study ourselves and each other. So there will for sure be a lot of upgrades, and the singles are going to get actually a lot more spicy today than yesterday.
Yeah, for sure. And talking about the strategy, something that I've noticed is our women's competitors really stepping things up more and more. It's like the most advancing part of skateboarding, and really exciting to see competitors. Let's hear from some of the top names out here in Rome.
Já é a terceira vez que eu venho a Roma para competir no skate, para a corrida olímpica, então estou super feliz. Sempre quando a gente vem, toda a cultura mesmo é muito legal e muito bonita.
Eu me sinto incrível, eu nunca imaginei que eu ia poder estar aqui.
I love coming back, because I mean, it's Rome. Can't say no to Rome. The thing I like about the park is that it's right by the Colosseum. That's pretty epic.
Brazilian and Japanese girls, they're really good and they're consistent and they jump into stuff.
I think they just practice really hard, and yeah, they just put their bodies on the line to land whatever trick I guess they want to.
Brasileiras e japonesas, a grande maioria, em quase todas as finais tem Funa, Momiji, Yumeka, enfim. Tem essas assim que tá sempre ali andando skate. Eu acho que o nível do skate feminino tem aumentado bastante. Tem muitas outras por trás que tá ali para dar o sangue também, para representar a nação delas, mas eu acho que todas ali na pista estão para dar o melhor.
When I skated, I could count the women on my hand. Like that was a new age just popping up from a different country, growing skateboarding.
My biggest goals is to compete in the Olympics and obviously try to get podium.
Como eu sempre disse, foi meu sonho para uma Olimpíada. Se eu conseguir estar lá presente, vai ser incrível, porque era meu sonho desde garota.
Estou super feliz de estar aqui para representar a seleção brasileira, representar os brasileiros, o povo brasileiro, a nação. Nos Jogos Olímpicos, eu estou como um pouco de cada vez, um campeonato de cada vez. I'm trying to get better at like controlling my emotions and not getting too upset, because I guess whatever happens, happens.
Just do my best and learn the tricks I have in mind.
Most of the day, about 31, a little bit of wind, so that's going to keep everyone cool, but humidity at 45 degrees. And it looks like we're pretty much ready to get things going. Let's take a look at our start list today. Gabby Mazzetto will be kicking things off. Good to see Momiji Nishiya in there as always. Liz Akama is our first place qualifier through, and we'll be starting things in reverse qualifying order. So she's going to get the luxury of sitting and watching what goes down and adjusting from there. You can see this amazing course. So many options, a little bit of everything in there you were mentioning earlier, Manny.
Yeah, there's a lot of everything. And then it's cool because you could start by going big or going trick into the Euro, trick on a double set rail. And the way I see it so far, a lot of people have been liking this route right here, especially the one that Gabby's taken, straight into the Euro gap and then to the double set rail. Really strong, really powerful.
And the thing with that double set rail and the double set itself, it's low, but it's long, right?
Yeah, it's sketchy. Like, if you skate the hubba or the rails, like, to get the speed for the rail, you have to be so committed to your trick, which shows how skillful the skaters are on the course, because it's not easy to commit to the double set rail once you get there.
And you were saying Gabby's pretty lucky to get through today.
Yeah, yesterday we had Coco went down during her best tricks, and Gabby was on the bubble. But it goes to show, sometimes in between skating, you don't want to try certain tricks because, you know, you don't want to end up falling during the practice. And then now Gabby's in the finals, giving us a good show, and she has one more run.
Yeah, Gabby's got a real good trick bag, looking so comfortable out there, and maybe a little bit more composed than yesterday.
Yes, yes. She has done a lot. You know, she had ACL surgery, then she became a mother. And she's probably the oldest girl on the course right now, and she's skating like it doesn't even matter. She's backsmithing the hubba, backtailing the hubba, and doing flips and slides, and you know, it's cool to see that, and I'm sure for the girls it's very motivating.
Yeah, just overcooking it a little bit on that backside 5-0 on the hubba there. And that thing's a little bit deceiving, isn't it? 52.8.
Yes.
0.8 coming through. You know, you've got the gap out. It's quite high, and it's almost like, you know, with the rails as well, as you approach some of these obstacles, they seem to grow and get bigger and longer.
And there's no back to the hubba, so you actually get lost when you pop.
Yeah.
So you have to prep for that.
So Miyu Ito in next, starting off where Gabby fell, the backside 5-0 straight into that backside lip slide. And Team Japan really are absolutely smashing it. And it's not just what they're doing, the trick choices and things like that. It's the execution. And that's what the judges are looking for out there, right?
Yeah. Well, Team Japan is the new Team Brazil. This was Brazil like 4 years ago. And you know what it is that they skate together, they have fun, and they really enjoy themselves. And they study what tricks they have to do, but then they also learn their own tricks. So they bring something new to the table.
I mean, you see that with Yuto, you see it with Sora doing the most awkward things that no one else wants to do. And the women are following in those footsteps as well, but really setting themselves apart from the men as well.
Yeah, 100%. Like, if you notice, Liz, not only does she do front big spins really well, but she also does the 180 Smith grind. And not even the guys are doing the 180 Smith grind. So she has her own bag of tricks, and it's really rad.
So there's that front side. Feeble gapping out to that one, waiting for that first run score to come in. 71.78. That is way up there for first run.
She almost choked on her water. She was so happy. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're just genuinely happy. Whether they get a good score or they fall, they just regroup and they keep this positive, beautiful energy, and it's contagious.
Yeah.
Like, it's...
And they approach it from a different view as well of, you know, you said they study the tricks. They know what needs to be done. And, you know, one of those people is certainly Momiji Nishiya.
She's one of my favorite to watch.
I mean, look at that.
You see that back foot just came right up. I don't know if she knows who Nick Trapasso is, but she's the female Nick Trapasso.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, it's amazing to watch.
And something, you know, she just looks so composed, like this doesn't matter.
No.
You know, and I think it's that attitude of, you know, this is no big deal. I'm just going to get out there and land my tricks. I don't care that there's 5,000 people watching. I'm just going to drop in and have fun.
And you know how they do that? By doing those tricks over and over and over and over. I've seen them all line up in a row and just do tricks over and over and over and over and over.
Yeah, it's certainly interesting watching some of the warm-up sessions and the practices.
Look at that.
Wow, gapping out to the back lip. Solid run there. And dare I say it, is it going to go higher than the 71.78?
I believe so.
And we were talking earlier about that trick selection, and that salad grind is definitely one of them, right?
Yeah, salad grind to one foot, you're into the crooked grind. She pieces everything together, and her thing is she makes everything look so effortless.
Well, I was going to say, style matters. And the judges, you can see those scores from people doing the same trick, but, you know, they're executed pretty much the same, but the people who make them look really good get 100%. Really good scores.
I mean, you got Vanessa Torres as one of the judges. She was a leading stylish and a leading woman in the sport.
Still is.
Yeah, but you know what I'm saying? Like, it's amazing. You got JB Gillette. Then look at that. 85. I think she's pretty happy. What do you think?
Yeah, I'd say she's happy. For sure. Okay, moving on through the heat. And I mean, you can tell just how many Japanese there are in this heat, just how well they're skating out there.
Yeah, 100%. They have a good program going on. And not only the females, the males too. They have a lot of amazing skaters out there.
Starting it off with that frontside lip slide. And we mentioned a couple of times during the weekend, but you have different approaches. You know, some people come straight out on their first run and put an absolute beast in on the course, throwing caution to the wind. And others, they'll build up a base layer to improve from. How do you approach it yourself?
I think, and this happened one time with Nyjah, one of a contest at his park. I like to always go first because I set the tempo. When you set the tempo, there's no pressure on you.
Sure.
So when you're waiting, you either have to do a safety run or you have to go for it. So I feel like the people that, when you start off first, if they just do what they want to do, they'll get it done without having to worry. See, the builder's pressuring. It's building right now. The girls are starting to realize, okay, I need an 85, I need a 71. And now they're going like, I have to do my second one first. Yeah. And those mental games start to take weight on your mind.
For sure. And adjusting on the fly is something that a lot of people are good at, but it can take its toll on your mind and how you're looking at things. And one of those things is if someone lands something slightly not how they wanted to, or they miss a trick, it's really hard to get back into the rhythm of what you've been practicing for the last 2-3 days, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, it happened to me. I fell on both tricks in my first run, and I was right when I fell, I knew. I'm like, there's 100 and something skaters.
Yeah.
Like, I knew, so, you know.
You can hear the crowd absolutely screaming for our next skater dropping. Chloe Cavell is literally at the forefront of women's skateboarding, pushing the limits right now. And we're watching it right in front of our eyes.
Yeah,
it's so exciting, and it's amazing to see.
It is. She's got a good switch flip. She's doing her own 50-50 kick flips. She's crooked nollie flipping, kick flip front board. Look at that.
Yeah, but it's how she's executing them. And she's a small person.
She's
tiny. And the pop that she's got is incredible. It shouldn't be possible. I love to see it.
100%. That's called will, the Australian will.
There's that switch frontside board slide.
Yes.
And something I noticed that the judges will be rewarding is people doing tricks into something else. So if you want to get switch and you're dropping in regular, turning round, whether it be a frontside flip or a switch flip or something like that,
yes,
like 180 down in the Euro gap,
yep,
to get to that other trick.
Yes.
And it's about that planning of the run,
yep,
and they like to see you, you know, using every bit.
Yeah, yeah, it's the fluidity within the run. And not like, say you do a back 270 lip to regular and then you have to go fake, you do this weird power slide to get to the other stance, it does take away from the beauty of the art form, which is skateboarding.
Yeah.
Because typically in the streets you don't do that.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, Chloe's one of those people that are doing that, you know. She's got so many switch tricks. You just saw that switch frontside board slide. The switch flips, you know, we saw last year the big switch board slides down the rail as well.
Yes.
And she's, you know, thinking about it. How do I get round to there? Because it's not the natural way that you'd want to do things.
She brings something new to the table, and it's important. Like,
yeah.
She literally brings something new. She sets herself apart by, you know, we all have our nollie crooks, kickflip 50s, big spin boards, right? But then we have our, you know, nollie flip feebles, very hard feebles. She has her switch from kickflip 50s. She brings something new to the table, and so does Yumika, and she's in right now.
Yeah. Landing bolts as always.
She's powerhouse.
And I mean, it looked like through from yesterday's semis. Oh, you know what? She barely misses that ever.
When I saw her do that the first time, I was in the crowd, and I literally jumped out of my seat, was like screaming because I love nollie flips, but it was the way she does them.
Oh, it's like she's landed 4 million of them and never fallen off.
Yeah.
The confidence, and I mean, that's something that we should talk about. You know, skateboarding is partly confidence, you know,
yes,
and believing to yourself that you are going to land the next trick.
100%. And when you see somebody, first off, when you see their legs not shaking and you see the excitement in their eyes when they go from one trick to the next, you know that that person is going to land their whole run and with poise and strength. They're going to go out there and do exactly what they want to do instead of letting the nerves allow them to do the trick. They're like, no. Nerves don't exist for this nollie flip right here. And it just so happened that, you know, it went the other way around for it.
But also, we're at the finals now.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's not just, you know, getting on the podium. We've got points as we go towards Paris 2024. So there's a lot more on the line. And, you know, you're skating for the honor of your country.
Yes.
And that's something that the Japanese, you know, they're very honorable and they love to do well.
100%. That's during the time when they announced the first Olympics, I was considering, like, stop competing. And then when I realized that I can represent my country, it gave me a new reason for wanting to pursue. That's really
unusual.
That's really unusual. What?
But you know what?
She's a
never
champion.
Ever get too chilled with skateboarding, because it will tell you that it's in control and you're along for the ride.
100%. And another thing I've learned is you don't sleep on Rayssa.
That's a way to come back from falling off, is it? You say that and she must be listening to you. Okay, right. Let's just go with the backsmith practice. And I mean, someone like Rayssa is really good at that. They'll go, okay, this one's not going to be the score that I wanted, so I'm just going to get a few practice tricks in. And I mean, her runs with a fall were scoring really high. So it shows you just how technical and how hard the tricks are that she's doing.
Yes, 100%. And, you know, we all love a story, and we love Raisa's, like, you know, her story of coming up to becoming this champion. But she also is now leading, and she's motivating the girls to be better. So now I feel like we have yet to see even the closest of the best Rayssa. And now she's going to be, the girls are getting better and she's getting even better.
Yeah.
Like, she's setting the tempo for them every time, and we will see it. Watch.
And with such a young field, there's so much time ahead. There's so much to come. And the level being that high now, you know, and that gap is closing between women and men.
Yes.
And it's closing so rapidly, and it's amazing. It's super exciting.
Yeah. I wonder what's going to happen when the girls are doing nollie flip crook on the Gato Hubba. We're just going to have no, there's going to be no genders. It's just 300 skaters on the course.
Yeah. I'm sure next year we'll be seeing it, and I we're here calling it for sure. So number one qualifier through from semifinals, Liz Akama. And you said it earlier, it's going to get more spicy, and we're already seeing it now.
Yeah, 100%. She put a little spice in her pasta, I'm telling you right now. She knows what it is. If she's already the number one qualifier, she knows exactly what she needs to do. Look at this.
Yeah, and that's the thing. You have the luxury of sitting there watching what the judges are scoring, watching what other people are doing.
Yes.
And you can sit there and go, okay, I might change up. I was going to hold up and maybe do this trick, but I'm going to put it in and spice it up.
Yeah, now because now she, because girls were missing, now she sets the tempo.
Yeah.
It would be the other way around. I mean, I don't see Liz not landing her run because I haven't seen her miss that run at all.
Yeah.
But it could happen. You know?
And I mean, it's, you know, Liz is one of those skaters that when she does miss it, we're confused.
Yes.
She gets confused as well.
Yes.
And I mean, the only thing that could take Liz out is herself.
Yes.
There's that gap out front feeble.
Yeah. There's that bag of tricks.
And this was where she changed stuff up.
Look at that 270 lip.
Yeah. So good.
Mini switch mid. Wow.
Good old barley grind going
look
in
out.
There.
Just happy, man. Just, who would have ever thought? Look at that.
88.61 coming through.
The battle for Japan now.
Yeah, way up there, but Chloe Covell is hot on their heels as well.
Yes. Oh, yeah, 100%.
So taking it back to the top of the heats. Run number two, and another 45 seconds on the clock for Gabby Mazzetto, starting it off with that big nollie down.
Very stylish.
Oh, crouching it out, but that makes a make.
That's power.
Yeah,
she's a
strong
powerhouse.
Legs. You can see that scar on her knee as well.
Yeah.
You know, that shows full power to come back from something like that. You know, it takes confidence, it takes fitness and training, and that's something that Gabby's been doing, right?
Yeah, it's like Conor McGregor says, right? Like, you gotta be obsessed.
Yeah,
you gotta be obsessed with skating to go through those kind of injuries, life-changing things, and still be up there in the finals of the best female women in the whole entire world.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
The best competitive stage within skateboarding in the world per country.
Yeah. It's I mean, I couldn't put it better myself, mate. Like, boom.
Yes.
It's right there on the plate in front 100%. Of us. 100%. And interesting skating there from Gabby, because she fell on the backside 5-0 on the first run. She changed it up, did back 50.
Yes.
Keeping it easier, knowing that you need a full run.
Yes.
To get through and to be up on podium. You're not probably going to get podium if you don't get a full run and get full scores.
100%.
But unfortunately, just
we'll
coming
see.
Off on that back
we'll
lip.
We'll see. I think if you don't get more than a 65, you're not making podium in your run.
Yeah, so that score getting heavily affected by that fall, 36.40. Yes. But sitting on that 52.08, it's still just about possible because she's got some really good best tricks.
As they say in Abra, ain't over to the fat laziness. That's what I'm saying. Like, you ain't never, I don't count nothing out of any situation.
Yeah.
You got one try left.
So, Miu, run number two, starting off as we saw it before. Rolling back in across that course, 30 seconds on the clock. Big kickflip. Be interested whether she changes this run up much. And looking really kind of composed and like there's all the time in the world. It's fine.
Yeah, she's got to pick it up from people.
Cruising back across, and that's something that I like to see, and that use of the quarter pipes. They're on the course, so you can use them. You know, it is a street
100%.
Competition, and there are transitions in there.
Yeah,
but that's one of the evolutions that I see, is the use of everything
the
on
fluidity.
The course.
But I think, to be honest, if she would have snuck one more trick in there, she would have got a better score. But she played the game of I did the tricks I wanted to do versus trying to sneak one more trick in. We'll see if that affects her.
Yeah, and with the likes of
Look
Vanessa judging, they know these skaters. Oh. They know if you're holding back.
Yo.
And they'll be like, nah, come on, I want to see more.
Yeah.
This is finals.
Facts.
You know, we want to see
Gladiators.
Everything you've got. Yeah,
yep.
Especially at the Colosseum.
Yeah, 100%. See, she got 3 points more, but nothing that's going to make that much of a damage right now.
But also, probably playing it safe, listening to coaches, and, you know, that's a new thing to skateboarding, having a coach.
Yes.
Before, it was like just your friends, like, get it, get out there and just shred. Now, it's this whole kind of evolution of competition skateboarding and making different choices.
Yes.
And sometimes you're emotionally attached to the comp, and you're like, you know, really getting wound up, you're hyped, especially someone like you. You're always bringing the hype, and you're in the moment. And sometimes it's nice to say, in your ear saying, hey, chill.
Someone needs to pull you back. And the thing is, I never thought that a coach would make much of a difference, especially in skateboarding, because it's a self-expression, right?
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, it helps a ton, and it makes a huge difference, because you need a voice of reason. Like, obviously, I'm like, yeah, I'm going to land this right here. But you need the voice go, hey, just do this one first. And then because you landed that one, you have all the confidence in the world, which will make you land the trick you actually want to do.
Yeah, exactly. The special bar will keep going up.
Yeah, straight up, like that
hanging
backsmith.
Hanging into that backsmith. And, I mean, this is what sets some of the other skaters apart, is not just being able to do the trick, but when the trick doesn't go fully right, being able to make those small adjustments, whether it be shoulder movement, arms, getting the balance right, and it's repetition that will give you that, isn't it?
100%, yeah. Repetition will always do that. There's no such thing as perfection, but repetition is the closest thing. It becomes muscle memory at that point. Wow.
I don't know. That front feeble was pretty perfect.
100%. She's making up for the last one.
Yeah, already sat on that 58.73.
Yes, sir.
That's where we saw it all start with the backsmith.
Holding on.
And that's the thing. When it goes wrong, it can really throw your run off. But the recovery here was really, really good.
I'll tell you what, the best to ever do it, when their run goes off, they know there's always a second strategy. Like, if I lean this way and it throws me towards this obstacle, they already go, oh, kick the 5-0.
Yeah, I've got something for that, or that, or that. And again, that's just spending time on the course and getting to know it and knowing where to go. Okay, taking it back round to our current third place position, 79.63. Looking good so far for Chloe Covell, but you know you've got to not hold back at any point.
No, you can't.
The finals, you don't have the kind of, oh, I'll just do what it takes to get through. This is it, all or nothing.
Yeah, you can't hold back. She knows if she wants to make podium, she has to put herself in at least second place.
Both that front feeble and the backsmith properly dips down. Oh. Kickflip 50-50, and that's the step up that we wanted to see.
Look, she didn't even have to do that heel flip.
No. But I mean, that's the kind of thing that will catch you out as well. But yep, she's got all of that stuff down.
Yep, 180.
So setting up for that switch trick, coming in, switch front side board slide, every go. Yeah,
I feel like
and that rail's high as well.
I don't even know how she does that, to be honest.
Yeah.
I feel like she got a little bit of Shane O'Neill in her. Look at this. Switch front board and switch flip.
Yeah.
Wow. She is excited.
I mean, I think there's going to be a new generation of women skateboarders coming into competitions that are going, oh, okay, that's what I need to do. I need to start skating switch.
Yes.
And then that pushes the overall level completely, doesn't it?
Yes, because it's like if you see it, you can believe it, right? So now the girls are seeing, oh, if Chloe can switch flip, so can I, right? Because she's like, I want to be like Chloe. I want to do the trick she's doing. And then that's the evolution. It's like what Rice has been doing. That's what Vanessa did. That's what all the girls, Christiana Means, Mariah Duran, all these people that have done tricks, and all these girls go, wow, you were my hero. And now, like, I'm so happy I could do these tricks thanks to you. That now she's on the forefront of doing that.
So 83.78 and remaining in that third place position.
That's what happens when you skate switch.
Okay. This is really shaping up to be something special, and seeing flawless runs just being thrown in the mix, and the way that everybody's looking at stepping up that second run at the moment.
Oh, yeah.
Yumika Oda is definitely going to be looking to do that. Currently sat in that sixth place position.
I remember the first time I seen her do a kill from Fibo on the rail in a contest, I lost it.
Yeah.
I literally lost it. Oh,
there you go.
See the whip on that flick?
Yeah.
Like
such
that.
A good flick on that toe.
Yep.
Catching the tail, spinning it round. There's the backside lip slide.
Yep.
20 seconds left. Looking really chilled. Not even out of breath.
Nope.
You know, the sun's gone just behind some of the trees, so probably a bit of relief.
Yep.
Perfect conditions for our finals. 10 seconds on the clock. Getting the front board done.
Yep.
Back tail. And she slides that all the way through as well. No popping off early, no sort of dips.
No.
Safety has, back tails, they're on top. Mm-mm.
She has full control of every single trick that she does. There's never like a, that she's not in control. From her kickflip front boards to her back over crooks to her back tails to her front flips to this nollie flip, she's always, she doesn't do tricks that she's not fully in control of.
Yeah.
And that's why we love to watch it, you know? And I believe that this was like the run she wanted to do the first time.
Exactly.
So she could have done the back over crook as the upgrade, and she could have. But guess what? Now she's going to have a good score. It's going to move her up the scoreboard, and she's gonna shine in the singles.
Yeah, exactly. And getting that 70.86. And when she was riding away at the end of that run, it was almost like relief. Right, I got that one run full that I wanted to get. Okay,
yes.
Maybe it's not exactly the one you wanted to do, but knowing that you've fallen on the first one, it's super important to get a full rundown. Then you're going to rely on your five best tricks afterwards.
Yeah, 100%. And Rayssa fell on the first one, so let's see if she can put it together and get a solid score on the board, which is, she's no stranger to it. Everything's fluid, everything's smooth, powerful, graceful.
You mentioned earlier about having another trick for the next obstacle. Rice is definitely someone who has.
Oh, like, yeah.
She could be looking the wrong way, turn around and be like, oh, there's a rail. I'll front feeble it.
Yes.
You know.
100%. Yes, this is what she does.
Dipping that backside Smith grind, making that look way too easy.
Yeah, for some girls, that's one of their singles, and she's doing it in her run. Because
she knows. You mentioned it earlier that we're seeing those best tricks in the runs. And we saw it yesterday. You're like, wait a minute, that was one of the single tricks last year. Now that's made it into your run? Wow, what are you holding back for us for best trick?
Yeah, 100%. She fell on the back tail on her last trick.
And I mean, that's risky, you know, going for the back tail. I mean, but she's got that trick,
but
still.
What does she need to do? She needs to go for it, right?
Yeah. I mean, that shows that Brazilian kind of attitude of like, I'm not holding back. I'm going all the way.
100%. I feel like when she back 50'd the bump to a rail, just doing a simple back 50 to go to the back tail, I think it messed with her mind that she needed to do everything versus just going for it, and then I think she would have landed the back tail. But she's a veteran already at a young age, so who am I to tell her anything, you know what I'm saying?
But also, when you get to that last trick, you've landed all of your run, and that, you know, the next trick, the, you know, that pressure builds up. And
it
comes to the last one, you're tired, you know, your legs are like slowly giving way, and then it's like, I need to land this.
Yeah,
so that pressure is on.
Yes, and she got a 70, which is actually a great score. Because she definitely has two nines for singles if she wants them.
For sure, I
feel like she can make it up there. But moving on to our number one qualifier into the finals here in Rome.
Yep. Last skater of this heat in the run section, and then we're going to be taking it on to best tricks.
There it is, 270 lip.
And knowing that the judges are looking to, well, I mean, from what we've seen with the judging, that repetition has been really affecting the scores out there.
Yes.
How important is it for you to change up your second run, even by one trick?
It's very important, because at the end of the day, you want to like wow them enough that it's almost like they accidentally slip the knob a little bit more. You know, like wow, like. And so if you switch one or two tricks, or if you're going to upgrade one, make sure it's a super upgrade. You need to do it. Playing it safe just to get a point two more is not going to make that much of a difference in the finals.
Sure. Yeah, it's like when your favorite track comes on, it's like, oh, I'm boosting this one up. Like, you know, that score goes up.
100%.
It's those replays for Liz.
Smith.
Oh. Rare to see her coming off of that one. Could be the pressure of the finals, but also she had a great first run score coming through, 88.61.
She's in a good spot right now.
Yeah, so you can afford to throw that one away, but you can never play it too easy. You can't get comfortable going, hey, I'm in first place, I'm chilling. Not at this level, at this point in the competition.
I'm going to tell you what, you can't even do that if you have a 9 for a score run, a 9 for one single, and you have 4 attempts left. You can't even do that, because you never know what someone's going to land. You know, Aurelien last year, hard flip, late flip over the hubba.
Yeah.
Hard flip back 180. Like, he didn't even expect to land that. So you never know what you're going to land. And you know everybody's, like, when we want to dig deep on those fantasy tricks, sometimes we do them when everybody's yelling, when it's on the line.
I mean, the atmosphere matters. Oof. When people are screaming, it's almost like your hairs all stand up and you're like, whoa,
it's
and you kind of ascend yourself a little bit.
100%.
Let's take a look at Liz Akama's run and see what you need to do to be going through in first place at the moment.
Front feeble, completely perfect, control, poise. One of the only girls to be doing 270 lifts in the contest right now.
You can see the bottom half of her body spinning round, shoulders holding it in position, and it's so hard to stop yourself from over-rotating on that one.
Yes, and especially she scoops. Like a Greg Luska used to ollie into it, she scoops into it. So for her to be able to scoop in, scoop back out, it's really impressive, to be honest.
For sure, and it's time to introduce the third member of our team, Samantha Bruce, who is courtside right now.
You ready? Hey, Roger, so we're going to be talking about Ayesa. Her first run, she fell on the first trick and the last trick, scored super low. How did she manage to adjust and come back from that?
The single trick is going to be the key, you know? It's going to be a lot of bangers. He trained a lot for that. He always get better in the single tricks. I can't wait to the single tricks now. That is strategy.
And do you think she'll be pulling out the kickflip back tail?
Yeah, for sure. For sure. He trained a lot in the arm up all week. That's going to be the key trick.
And also, so what's her mentality, obviously, after the first run and it not scoring high? What do you think is going through her head?
You know what? Skateboard, everything is going to happen, you know? She trained a lot. She's a confidence. She trained, but she's chill. You know, no problem for us.
Great. Thank you so much for that. And back to you.
Thank you very much, Sam. Some great insights there. And we are now taking the competition over to our best trick section. Each skater has had 2 45-second runs. And one of those scores has to count to the overall three.
Someone went down.
Yeah, there's always that risk with skateboarding. And we've got really, really good medical team joining us out here in Rome. So they're in very, very good hands. They're making their way over. But now we take it over to that five best trick. And we're going to see kind of that educational side of the competition skateboarding now. So people who haven't quite got the run that they wanted, they're now having to rely on building those points up in this best trick section. And we had while that interview was going on, we were talking about a few predictions of what we thought we're going to see. And I think Rayssa is in a position now where she knows she can rely on certain tricks, but the pressure's going to be there as well.
100%.
How do you think she's going to be moving forward with this?
I think if I was her coach, if I was Roger, I would have her start with, from blunt. just to get something, just to get that confidence flow, right?
Yeah.
Then I would have her do a kickflip back 50 to get two really high scores, and then she has, you know, the three attempts to go either kickflip back tail, kickflip back Smith, which will bump one of her scores super up and put her on podium. But it could be up to Rayssa to tell Roger, like, hey, I really feel the kickflip back tail. I'm going to go straight for the kickflip back tail and see what happens. But in order for Rayssa to make a podium, she's going to have to do what she does. And she does it really well. So
yeah, for sure.
Either or, she's going to be okay.
I mean, someone who always stands out to me and has stood out to me from the beginning, Momiji.
Oh, yeah. 100%.
Has a great approach to this. And, you know, we mentioned it earlier. She's just chilling. I can see her warming up a few big spins. So I think we're going to see that gap out, big spin frontside, boardside, because
yes.
That scored really well yesterday.
Yes.
So obviously we only get the repetition rule daily. So a new day today.
Yeah.
You're not going to get scored down for it.
Yeah.
You hear the crowd giving a few cheers as she moves off of the course. But, yeah, it's interesting that the skaters know what scores came in yesterday and having their scores on the board at the moment, they know what it's going to take to be up in the top of the pack.
Yeah, they already know. And, you know, you see the tricks in practice. Momiji was doing crook nollie heels on the hubba, which is probably going to be, if she does do that, it'll be the high score trick of the weekend. And she also could do big flip front board on the bump to rail.
Yeah, for sure. Super exciting. And, we're going to take it back down course side with our third member of the team, Sam Bruce, who's joined with my guest yesterday, Tommy Finn.
Hey, Tommy Finn. So obviously the competition's super high at the moment. Chloe's doing really well. How does she keep her composure with there's so much on the line?
I know. She's so good at doing that. She's just having fun the whole time. I think she's only 13 years old. She's so young. And she just has a good time. Has fun. It's I guess it's good. She's young, the nature of being young, right? Not taking it too serious at all, even when people are cheering and all of that scores on the line doesn't matter to her.
And obviously we've just seen a slam. I mean, that's enough to kind of put anyone off. How do your riders kind of deal with that? Does it put them off or?
Yeah, no, that's snarly. A lot of the girls are going for it out here. It's pretty crazy. A lot of score on the line, big obstacles, and they're still pushing on them. It's crazy, and a lot of slams. But it doesn't put Chloe off at all. She's super brave, and I'm just so proud of how she's doing, and she just stays composed and goes for it.
And, you know, you don't need to give too much away, but has she got any kind of new tricks up her sleeve for best tricks in this final round?
Yeah, she does. She has a lot more to offer this year than she did last year, and really that's so much progression she has, and I'm just proud of her. I don't want to give too much away, but wait and see her wait for the best trick.
I mean, obviously, the 50-50 kickflip out was amazing. Are we going to be seeing kind of something added onto that?
Yeah, 50-50 kickflip out. I mean, I think switch front board might be coming. We've been talking about it in the long rail. She has a really good switch front board. She doesn't know that. That'll be her biggest one yet. So hopefully that goes down.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your time.
Imagine your coach being Tommy.
I'd be hyped.
I wish Tommy. How good you're going to get.
Tommy's one of the best, man.
Yeah, he joined me yesterday. It was great to hear some of his insights into the skating, and yeah. I'm stoked that you're here with me, mate.
You know, 100%. Me and Tommy are two peas in a pod, but this is what I said about Tommy. I said, imagine Tommy coaching you, right, and then them telling you, hey, I don't want to do this trick or whatever. And then Tommy's like, I'll nollie heel back nose blunt this. You better stop it.
Yeah, exactly. Come on, this isn't even like hard. Yeah. You're like, yeah, okay, but you are Tommy. So it looks like we're gearing up for getting on with our best tricks. Five tricks anywhere on the course, but it looks like a lot of people concentrate on that gap to hubba.
Yes.
That's where the money's at, right?
Yep, the long rail and the gap to hubba. There's Gabby stacking her points.
Yeah, and I mean, that's playing things, like we were saying earlier, a little bit safe.
Yes.
Get that one trick down. Have the confidence that you've got a trick on the board. Now
yes.
Four goes at something more difficult, right?
Yeah, 100%. But you know there's another tactic, right? If you know you're down and you run really low and, like, you're going to try to jump three spots, what about you land five tricks, five for five? They might not be the highest, but then in Switzerland, she's going in there with finals, all single trick in her mind.
Yeah.
This is a long
exactly.
game, not a short
yeah,
game.
Yeah, for sure. And, I mean, we got five more events to come up at the tour.
Yeah.
So,
confidence
yeah, playing that
key.
Long game,
mm-hmm.
you know, and obviously your finishing position gets you those points that go
yes.
towards it.
Yes.
22 people that are going to get through to Olympics. That's a tight cut.
Yes.
And that's the long game that you need to play, right?
Yeah, 100%. You have to. It's not about it's about each event at the moment
yeah.
and not letting one bad, two bad events. Because even at the last event, if the rule still sticks, I believe, at the last event, if you podium, you go. That's how it
Boom.
Was last time.
Yeah,
that's how Jagger got in.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, He was telling us yesterday in an interview, you know, he was like, whoa, I got in. That's crazy.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that can change everything.
Yeah. Look at that.
So 75 for that 1-9 coming in. Yeah, good to see.
Momiji.
So, focused. Already got an 85.60 sitting in fourth place at the moment. Momiji dropping in.
Oh.
Yep, that's what we saw. She was warming that one up. And I think she's maybe thinking she was going to do that first go there.
Yes,
and
she for sure,
you know, how does that affect you when you're so confident about doing something and it doesn't go right? What do you do to get your head back in the game?
You either go back and try it again, knowing that you're willing to, like, land it, or your coach will tell you, hey, go do backsmith and then try that.
Exactly.
And sometimes that helps you because you're going into the trick landing a trick versus, like, getting stuck on one trick, four tries, five tries. It happens.
And, I mean, that's the skateboarder in everybody here. It's the stubbornness. You don't get good at skateboarding without repetition and without hurting yourself constantly.
Yep.
Oh, I mean, we're all holding some sort of injury.
Yeah, 100%.
Okay. Chloe Cavell coming in. Big kick flip. Boom. There we go. That's going to be the confidence and the base layer that she's now going to put a beautiful cake together for us.
Yep, that's the frosting.
Yeah.
That's the white frosting or whatever color you want. Then you get to draw on it, put the little animals on it, and a little candle.
And obviously, the judges are scoring certain things throughout the weekend, and everybody's writing those scores down. That's something that we've not really seen before. And
this is new to me,
it's
too.
It's this whole thing of, okay, that trick, I can do that every go, pretty much, and it scores this. I've already got this score on the board, so all I need to do to get the highest score of the weekend is that trick, and that trick.
Yes.
And then they can choose between, the judges can choose between them. So it's that educational part and that experience of competitions. But that experience is coming through in the youngest riders on the course.
Yeah, it's like they're taking math classes without being in school on the course and getting AA pluses.
Yeah. We're seeing some A pluses.
World Skate, you guys are, you know, it's a traveling school for
There's
the kids.
Some scholarships getting handed out.
World Skate scholarships. Chloe's definitely getting a scholarship.
So we saw Aoi take
back
a slam earlier, and she's going to be dropping in.
She's okay.
Struggling to get up on there, and this is pure athleticism right now. And the thing is, you don't get those points unless you drop in.
Yeah.
Right? We've seen that before, and we've seen people trying to get that ranking. You're not going to get the score on the board unless you drop in. And it's so hard to come back from a slam, and you can see she's composing herself there. And just do something you like the feel of.
Yes.
You know, just have fun with it. At this point, you need to compose yourself, get rid of it, throw that one away. It never happened, right?
I would just 5-0 the hubba. Just to get a feel to be back on the course. But guess what? She's not going to do that. She's going to try to
straight back in there. 13 years of age and showing super confidence. You saw her just slipping out of it. And I think that was what she fell on earlier. And that shows some unbelievable bravery there.
Yes.
Because, you know, when you've hurt yourself on a trick, you're riding towards that same trick that just took you out, telling yourself, it's all right.
Yep.
Everything's okay. You're lying to your brain, but sometimes your brain will shout louder than you.
Yeah.
And she's getting back up on the platform, getting pulled back up onto the platform there, and still willing to keep going. And that's that determination that we see, from everyone out there.
That's the beauty about skateboarding. You fall, you get up.
Yumika in there, kicks it, 50-50. Look at that, riding away, hands in the air. But that's what I love to see, that passion and that whole, like, I did it!
Mm-hmm.
It's so hard to put into words.
Yeah.
Boom.
Straight to seven, Braden.
And I mean, we're talking about bolts yesterday, landing bolts, your feet both above those truck bolts. That's the kind of thing where you might just get 0.5 more of a score than someone else who doesn't land it as clean, right?
Yeah, 100%. And she did that completely perfect. She got an 86.59, which is an amazing score.
Yeah, that sees her up there in second place right now. And to get that out of the way so early, that's special, right?
Oh, my God. If your first two attempts, you do the two tricks you want to do, you're the next three, you're on a hiatus. You're just like, it don't even matter, so you're willing to try whatever you want.
DJ Redbeard absolutely smashing it all weekend with the music.
All All right, let's see if what Rayssa is going to do. Do I know
her? There you go.
Do I know her?
I was thinking that she might take it easy just because of how the run section went, just to build up a bit of confidence, but no. Straight in with the front blunt.
Front blunt. Guess what's coming next? Kickflip back tail.
Kickflip back tail. Yeah, and I mean, if those two go down, what else can we see from her?
She'll kickflip back.
Kickflip back Smith.
Yes.
Rail or Hubba, though?
Hubba.
Okay, because I saw her try and kickflip back Smith maybe yesterday, or but she also has that flick and really accurate catch.
Yes.
That sometimes it looks like a back Smith, but it's going back lip.
Yes.
But she can do both.
Yes, 100%. She's playing the game. She's one of the best.
85 coming in there.
She's one of the best at playing the game.
So jumping up into that third place after that one. And we're taking it back round to our current leader, Liz Akama. Or our leader as we went through from the run section, sorry.
That'll bump her back up to the top for sure.
And there's that frontside 180 switch, Smith.
She makes me want to learn that trick. Like, she does it really well.
Yeah, it's the way she does it. Sometimes that can look like a bit of a weird trick.
Yeah.
And she makes it look really good.
Yes, 100%.
And it's the body position, I feel, that when she does the front side 180, she lands in a switch Smith as if it was a regular Smith.
Yes. And she does that lean. Look at that. Back to the top spot.
Yeah.
She's excited.
Okay, we're taking it back to the top of the heat. Tricks number two of five. Trick two for Gabby Mazzetto. Oh, perfect. Look at her face on the ride out. Yes. Now that's two on the board.
Yes.
Front board all the way down the long rail and the backside Smith.
This is all confidence building. I'm telling you right now. She's playing the game. Because guess what? If she does this in singles and she does it under so much pressure, guess what she's going to do in her run next time around?
Yeah, exactly that. And, I mean, that's the evolution we saw earlier. These tricks that we saw last year are now being done in runs, and it's making way for incredible tricks during the best trick section.
100%.
Okay.
Actually, it's just a five.
Trick two of five, Miu.
In first.
Oh, wow. So slipping out of that one. Still three more tricks left, though. And at that point, you know, it's when you get to the final two and you haven't got a score on the board, knowing that you need two tricks.
Yes.
So that's so important to get that first trick out of the way, right?
Yes, 100%, because then you're not leaning on these are the two most important tries of my life to do two tricks that I haven't practiced as much as the rest of my runs.
So Momiji back in, going for this big spin front board.
Oh,
I think she thought she'd landed that then.
Yeah, she hit her head, but luckily she got a helmet on. She'll be okay. Uh-oh. That smile. Come on, Momiji. Let me get that smile back.
Yeah. Just like yourself, one of the most recognizable smiles in skateboarding, mate.
Oh, my God. It's the tooth. I swear it's the tooth.
Okay.
She's going for it. Is she going for it?
Back up there. Looks like maybe gap out.
Back Smith. Oh, back lip.
Back lip. That, you know what? Coming back from a slam, changing the trick up is exactly what you were saying earlier.
Yes.
Step away from it for a bit, listen to the coach, and maybe come back to it, or maybe just scrap it.
Yeah, just if you're taking two heavy slams and you're trying to boost your confidence again, the last thing you want to do is something that's going to make you question yourself like the front people did for her. You just, at this point, just do a couple of tricks, and then if you want to go for it again, go for it again. But till then, you know, like I remember I said, long game. This is a long game. You want to save that body. You don't want nothing bad to happen.
So 75.63 and another trick on the board. Or another score on the board, bolstering that run section. So we're taking it back to Australia's Chloe Covell up next. 83.78 and an 85.53 is good enough for third, but she wants to step it up.
Frontside flip, I'm calling it.
Okay.
Oh, no. What?
She's solid crooked grind, though. I think this
she's
is
playing
this
the game.
Exactly that.
She's
playing the game. Get another score on the board. Now three goes at a frontside flip, right?
Yeah,
or maybe that switch frontside board slide that we heard about.
I think she's going to do 50-50 kick flip.
Okay. Well, I mean, imagine having that many options for best trick.
At 13.
Yeah,
in at 13. Big, in a massive big section. Like, this is not a little big section. It's a big section.
Yeah, I walked around the course last year and this year, and you kind of forget, like, you might come to this thing going, oh, you know what, I've got this trick now, I've got this. And then when you get here, you go, oh, wait a minute, this thing's actually way bigger than I remember.
Yep, 100%.
Yumika back in. Kicky front board. Wow, that's two heavy tricks on the board. It is looking great for Team Japan right now. I'm interested to see where this goes. Many people out there doing that.
It should score high because she's taking the risk. She's flipping her board. And I hope, you know, the judges know what they're doing. But they got to remember, like, you flipping your board, there's a bigger margin for error than there is if your board is staying on your feet.
Yeah, high risk as soon as it leaves your feet because you're out of control. But with high risk, it's high reward.
That's right. Let's see what they give her. She needs an 84 to be in first. And that should,
that's not out of the question, is it?
No, that should do it.
Oh, 88.93, one of the highest scores we've seen over the weekend. And certainly jumping up by a couple of points nearly into that first place position as we take it back down to the Brazilian Rayssa Leal, currently in fifth and definitely looking to change that.
Yeah.
Coming back in towards that hover. You called it right. Trying for the kick flip backside tail slide and just landing back on the board and slipping out. Going to take a breather. Gabby's getting straight over there. Check her butt. Do you know what? Rice is one of the toughest kids I've ever seen. The things that she gets up and walks away from are incredible.
Yes, 100%. You know what's good about the evolution of skating in the female world is that they need to see those slams. So they need to see that they get back up so that it encourages the girls who do fall. Like, hey, this is scary and I might get hurt, but guess what? I could get up too.
Yeah.
So it's very important. Like, we don't want to see nobody fall, but it's also important for the culture of skateboarding that if you fall, you get back up.
Okay, perfect. 180 nose grind.
Just playing the game.
Yeah, that's another score on the board.
Yeah.
And now that takes the pressure off of having three attempts at something that maybe you're not that consistent with.
Yes. You know what? What is she going to do next? I've seen her do all the tricks that we know that she can do.
Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah. Like, and I mean,
what's the bag looking like now?
Yeah, exactly. Maybe we might see the board spinning a little bit. She's got a great big spin. 80.96 coming through. And back in to that familiar place of first. And we're going to take it back to the top of the heat. Trick number 3 of 5 for Gabby Mazzetto. And she's looking pretty stoked, I think.
Yeah,
looking really confident and composed because those two scores on the board that go with the run section.
Yes. Regardless of what happens, she's put on 3 scores, and that's very important. Whoa!
Okay, stepping it up. Yep. Kick flip backside lip slide, but that's also a sloped rail, so you're stepping up out of the bank, down onto the rail, and there's that wedge that's there as well to miss.
And up over the Euro, too. So the girls are pushing Gabby to be greater.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the thing. When you're already that good, but you're seeing what some of the younger generation are doing, it's pushing her level up, you know, after every trick.
Yes. Like right now, like Jinwoo is our motivation because we know what he's going to be coming with these next couple of years.
For sure.
Ooh.
Oh, out to front blunt. And that was solid as well, all the way to the end.
Made it look easy. Love that.
I mean, that's the thing, though. Are the judges going to be saying, that was that easy for you? We've seen it before. We know that you've got that as your trick. They're going to score it as a front blunt, of course, gapping out. But it's all about pushing that limit, and they want the progression of skateboarding to be going bigger and better every single competition.
Yeah, they score the progression, and she did it in her run, but she still got,
heavy score, 84.64, and that's good enough for fourth place right now. And we're taking it back round. We got 2-0 scores on the board for Mamishi. It's going to be important to get this one down, and there you go, changing it up, getting a confidence builder, something that feels good as well, and just being like, okay, cool, I'm still in the game. It's not over yet.
It's about playing the game. It's about recognizing that there's an error, and how can you fix that error? Okay, let me get a score. Then I have 2 more tries to do a crazy trick, and now does she go bitching from board or crook nollie heel? Crook nollie heel, does it look like it? Her hands are doing crook nollie heel.
Yeah, and I mean, I was just about to say, you see a lot of people sort of visualizing tricks in their head, and sometimes just being able to see yourself do the trick can be like the programming you need to be able to do it, right?
Yes. Yep. As skaters, we skate with our hands. if you notice, like, we'll do, oh, kick flip back tail. You do it with your hands.
Yeah.
So that's the secret out the bag when you see
someone. Visualization.
Yes.
Okay, already got 75.63 on there. Trick 3 of 5 for Aoi. Wow. Coming back from a heavy slam and then throwing yourself fully into something that you could really do yourself in on again. That shows just how good she is.
Shows heart.
Yeah. Passion, heart, and look at that. The crowd are really screaming for her. They can see how much pain she's in, and she's not giving up. No way.
No, not at all. She's fighting until the very last trick.
So back round to Chloe Covell. Got that 85 and a 72 on there. I'm excited to see where we're going here.
This is where we see the bag. There it is.
Okay, coming towards that long rail, front 50-50. Kickflip out. Wow!
The Joe Rogan moment.
Wow, first go and perfect as well. That was so bonkers.
Wow.
The crowd are going crazy. We're going crazy. Look at the passion. Wow. I love to see it. And you know what I'm thinking now? Maybe we're going
to
see that switch front board, Manny.
We're going to.
Yeah. Because after that, she is going to be on cloud 9. Yeah. The confidence level is going to be through the roof.
Yeah.
And that's what you're going to need to be able to hold on to a switch front board down such a long rail.
Or she upgrades her 85 for a kickflip and does a frontside flip and gets a 9.
Well, okay. Okay. And I mean, you're talking about dropping 80s.
85. To,
yeah. Dropping a score in the 80s. Yeah. That is crazy.
Yeah. I'm so excited.
This is going to be through the roof. I mean, we've never seen it. 92.12. And your new leader, Chloe Covell from Australia, 261.43. And rightly so.
Frontside flip, Tommy. Tell her to do frontside flip, Tommy.
I mean, we're on the verge of seeing 5 tricks from her.
Yeah.
Like, she's getting so good and so consistent over the weekend. It's not out of the question.
I'm so happy for her.
Taking it back to Yamika. Wow, you called it out earlier.
I already know. I know. I study this game.
You know your Yamika well.
I study this game, man. I support and I show love and I'm there and I'm just... I feel I'm like I'm a part of the hype. I'm in the crowd. Meaning I'm in the crowd. I see tricks and I'm like, wow, I can't believe what's happening right now.
For sure. And I've just had an update that Rayssa is going to be skipping this next trick, taking a 0, but that's going to put the pressure on those next 2. And I think sometimes you just need a little bit of time to recover, get things straight in your head, and then come back stronger. Liz Akama. Wow. Stepping out. Frontside 180. Switch Smith. 180 out. The barley grind.
We'll see if there's a repetition deduction, meaning like, because she did it on the hubba. She did it just straight, but it's the same trick.
Yeah, that's the thing, and I think...
This is where the bag's got to get deeper. This is why you can't rely on only 3 tricks, you know?
Yeah, and I mean, we've been mentioning it all weekend. That's the one thing that the judges have been hanging on a lot, is that repetition. But
we'll
let's
see. It can't be more than the hubba, and the hubba was 85.
Sure, and I mean, already got an 88.61 on the run section, so looking really good.
Yeah, 79.36
coming through. You can see there. Oh, yeah. Okay.
It's
yeah,
the repetition.
That's what it is.
Has to be.
Okay, we're going to take it back to the top of the heat. Trick number 4 of 5 for Gabby Mazzetto.
Look at how happy she is, man. It makes me so proud. As a friend, as an old teammate, like, I am just so happy for her.
So, going back to the kicky back lip. Oh, you know what? Third go.
She's going
to
do it.
Third time's a charm.
She's going to do it.
I think if she does it, the crowd is going to go nuts. She's going to go nuts.
Yes.
And it's going to definitely set her out of that middle position that she's in at the moment. And is it going to be enough? Currently on a 200, third place is 246.38. It's doable. It's doable, right?
She'd have to do it completely perfect. Yeah.
But there's no one else doing that trick on that obstacle.
True. But it's not a big obstacle, and the judges... Oh, my.
Okay, that would have been a first, I think, of the weekend.
Of the weekend,
flip,
for sure.
All the way out.
Yeah. The only other one that could do that, that would do that, is Mariah Duran. And
yeah.
If she had a single, she would have hard flipped that. So.
I think we saw her when we were here the first year in Rome at the Olympic Park.
Yeah.
She put the best one I think I've ever seen her do. And that set of stairs was big as well, wasn't it?
Yeah. I'm even surprised not to see Mariah in the finals, but hey. There's a lot of competition out there.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, you called it out earlier. Crooked grind, nollie heel.
Yes.
Pressure is on now. One last attempt.
Yes.
You can see from the body language.
Yeah, her body language isn't excited right now.
No.
And that's, you have to lie to yourself as a skater that you're excited.
Yeah, totally. And I mean, having seen what Chloe's done, what do you reckon that's doing to shake up the rest of the field?
Everyone. They're all confused. They're like, how do we... I think everyone's literally just fighting for a second at this point, because we'll see. I mean, once again, there's
you can never get comfortable ever. Okay. Coming in for trick 4 or 5, and it's a make.
Wow.
Aoi smashing it. Look at the passion coming out, and rightly so. The crowd is going wild for her. And I mean, what composure to come back from a bad slam and put a heel flip, frontside board slide down like that. And I mean, even though that's a shorter distance, it's still a long way to go once you've landed in a slide, especially when you flipped in.
Yeah, she's flipping in. She's blind. She took two gnarly front feeble slams on the same rail on the opposite side. She's in tears, and she's dropping in heel flip front boarding. She has won my respect, and I'm going to... Wow.
There you go, 92.84. Currently in fifth, but that pushes Gabby down into that sixth place position. Amazing skating.
Wow.
So far,
here we go.
This is the start of the show. Chloe Covell, 92.12 for that last trick. Front side 50-50, kick flip out. Okay, where are we going now?
Frontside flip.
You called it. That's a big old frontside flip. I mean, the likes of Aurelia doing that.
Yeah.
You know, we're not seeing that so much from the women. We saw the kickflip that she did earlier, and now that's the upgrade you were talking about.
Yeah.
And at the moment, dropping an 86.59 is nuts, isn't it?
This is amazing. I'm so glad I'm a part of the witness of all this. Like, amazing skateboarding. Like, I get to witness this firsthand, this evolution of skating. Like, from the Alexis Sablones to then this. It's like cool, you know? Like, it's very humbling and very inspirational.
Yeah, 100%. And like I said earlier, this is one of the fastest progressing parts of skateboarding that I've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, you can't help but get caught up in it.
Yeah.
You know, it's like we're on the edge of our seats, but we're losing our minds out here.
Yeah, look, we got one right here.
Okay, decided to not do the last trick. So pressure's on the next two.
Switching it up.
Wow, to come back from a slam, you can see the grimace on her face there.
Yeah,
but holding that backside Smith grind all the way through, that rail is so long.
100%. I didn't backsmith it, I'll tell you that much.
And I mean, that's the thing. Like, years ago, you'd be like, oh, okay, yeah, like you could see yourself doing some of these tricks. Now I'm like, there ain't no way I'm going anywhere near that thing.
I'm not saying I can't, I'm just saying I didn't.
Oh, I'm saying I can't, for sure.
She makes it look easy, though.
Yeah, good day for me.
She took a gnarly slam.
To come back from a slam, like...
You got there, new backswing.
There'd be some points.
Oh, yeah. She knows
there you go, 84.66. And currently in fourth place. We've only got our top three here, though.
Yes.
There's three positions to take, and that battle is incredible right now. Wow. Okay. Frontside feeble.
Showing some new tricks.
Frontside 180 out. Such an awkward trick, because the nature of that trick, the way you have to hold it and the way you have to point it and then bring your front foot back over the rail almost to get it out.
100%.
And the landing is quite low on that rail as well, so there's not much time to get it done, so you've got to get the pop out.
Yeah, it's a Japan thing. Kayaki was doing its switch on that same rail from the long side.
Yeah, that was bonkers.
It has to be a Japan thing.
Yeah. So fifth and final trick for Gabby Mazzetto. Charging with a Benihana. We called it out yesterday. We hadn't seen one Benihana. I really wanted to see her go back and get the kickflip back lip, though,
me
mate.
Me too, but I think their team knew it wasn't going to be enough. Better for her to go out on her shield and make, you know, do something for the crowd and
yeah.
and know that, look, she's went from, you know, qualifying to, look, seventh place right now.
And, I mean, just to get through to finals is such a massive achievement, especially with the level of skating we've seen this weekend.
Yes, semis is like a bigger finals.
Oh. Whoa! Getting feet back on it, but not quite making it. Miu Itu.
All right.
Finishing with that 75.19 and 84.64 in our
All right,
trick
Miu.
Section. Gabby still going. Yes, that's what I like to see. You know what? That's the rebellious side of skateboarding and that kind of determination thing. Like, no, I'm getting that. I'm getting it. I don't care. I don't care if I'm going to stall the whole competition. Yeah. I'm going back up there and getting it done.
Do it for the crowd.
So someone I really want to see get this last trick. Trick five of five for Momiji Nishiya. Oh, wow. Getting feet on it, but not quite enough.
You know what, though? She went for the hardest tricks. She is pushing the limits of skateboarding, and sometimes in order to push the limits you have to fail.
I couldn't say it better, mate.
You know,
like, that's
saying?
That thing. And I mean, the difficulty of this stuff, that you can't land all this stuff all the time.
She could have worked her way into third place by doing other tricks, but she wanted to do the stuff that's going to put her on the podium, and that's important.
Okay. Aoi back up there. Fifth and final trick. We've seen amazing spirit from her this weekend. Going kickflip, frontside board slide. Already got that 75.63 and the 92.84. And imagine, like, a 92.84 on the board and only in sixth. Yeah. That shows you the level of skateboarding above her at the moment. It is absolutely bonkers.
Yeah, and it shows you how important the run section is.
Exactly that, so yeah.
It's vital. It's a vital organ. Oh, and it comes down to a couple more skaters.
Yep, Chloe Covell, trick five of five.
She could do this if she really tried to stick it, because she did it in Dubai.
Yeah.
It's the same height.
But knowing who else is coming up, you're going to need to try and increase that level.
Yeah.
And we keep saying it. To drop an 85.53 would be crazy.
She can land it.
Oh, wow. That impact, that shows you how high it is up there. I mean, it's above her head height.
Yeah.
It's a huge, huge gap. You've got to come off that platform, clear the gap over the bank. And, I mean, you don't want to land on the end of the bank because the judges are going to go, you didn't do the whole thing.
No, they'll dock it. Yeah. They've been really strict about the time when you pop your last trick, repetition, and how you do the tricks. And I really love that because that's what we need. The judges are being fair, and it's you know, the people that are playing by the rules are getting the best.
So dropping in for that fifth and final. Yumika needed a 95 for first.
Oh, man.
Do you think the kickflip frontside feeble would be up there, 95?
Yeah.
I think so. Yeah.
It might even be because the heel flip front board was a 92.
Yeah.
It might even be a 96, a 97. Like, no one's doing that. You gotta reward the skater for doing the stuff that nobody's doing at a high level.
For sure. And I mean, look at that. For second, 98.89. For third, 90.48.
She can get into third. Kickflip back tail. I don't know if they'll give it a 98.
But that's the trick that took her out. And with her confidence and skill level, the two match together. This will happen.
Yeah.
Like, you know, the pressure's on. This is last trick. You can hear the crowd whistling. They're like, come on, you've got this.
These are the dream scenarios that you fantasize about.
For sure.
I have one more try.
Do you know what is incredible to me is the other skaters in this heat are down there cheering for her as well.
Yeah,
the camaraderie is incredible.
That's the beautiful thing about skateboarding.
Going for it. Not quite turning those shoulders round enough, but amazing skateboarding all weekend, as always, from Rayssa.
Yes.
And that's, I want to just jump back to what I was saying before. The camaraderie is incredible. You're cheering for someone that's possibly going to knock you out off of the podium.
Yeah, that's the
that's the skateboarding spirit.
That's skateboarding. At the end of the day, we don't want no one to really fall. We don't want no one. You know, if you want to win, you're going to win on your shield, and that's important.
For sure. So, 85.
Means 87.
Front feeble, front 180. Wow. She's shocked to see it. I am. But is that going to be enough to knock Chloe Covell off of that first place position. That's what she's going for.
We'll see.
Team Japan skating so good so far. So 85.22, 80.96, joining that 88.61. I think we're going to see an upgrade on it. So gap out, frontside feeble, frontside 180 out.
She did it good.
Yeah, really well. You can see from the speed that she rides away with that it was done really, really well. And that execution is what the judges are scoring heavy on. So nerves at the moment. There's our top two.
Oh, man, the judges.
Come on, stop doing this to us. Oh, wow, we're waiting for that last trick to come in. 19.07, and it is enough. Jumps up there by over 2 points. And that is our winner there, Liz Akama, coming through with all the power in the final hour.
She qualified first and held on to her spot.
But she is massive shout out to Chloe.
Yeah. Oh, no, 100%.
It
crushes my heart to see it happen, but it also makes me happy to see the level of skateboarding be pushed on the last try.
Yeah.
You take your throne back, and that is beautiful. Yeah. Sad for Chloe, but happy for Liz.
But to lose to Liz, you know, that's she's so, so good.
Yes.
Wow. That's a massive achievement. So top three there, Yumika Oda, Chloe Covell, and Liz Akama. Amazing skating from Rayssa. Just missing those two attempts on the kickflip back tail. And taking a bit of a slam and that knocked that confidence. But great skating from Gabby Mazzetto as well, right?
Yes, 100%. Wow, what a good finals.
Oh, incredible finals. It's been so incredible.
A bunch of new tricks. A win on the last try of your attempts, and camaraderie and cheering and love and tricks and wow.
I couldn't write it to be any better.
You know what I'm saying?
And it's a full encompassment of skateboarding in one event. Like, it's so amazing to see. And skateboarding wins yet again.
Can we get a YouTube show with all this written out and then... Sheesh. Wow, what an ending.
Amazing, absolutely amazing. So you can see barely a seat spare in both sides of our stadium here. And you can see in the background there, we're literally in the shadow of the Colosseum.
Yeah, the gladiators went at it. Wow.
I'm so proud of skateboarding. I'm so proud of women's skateboarding, and to be able to sit here and call it with you, I'm so stoked, mate. Thank
amazing.
You.
No, I had a great time. This is awesome. It's awesome. The samurai beat the gladiator today.
Yeah, for sure. So we're going to jump back down courtside to Samantha Bruce.
Liz, congratulations. So it's been a long time that we've been waiting for the first street competition. How does it feel now?
So she competed two competitions for this season, but she hasn't been on the podium, and now she's on the podium, so she's happy.
And what was going through your head for the very last trick? You were in second place, and then with the last trick you managed to go to first place. What was going through your head?
ファーストトリックする時は、ファーストトリックの時はまだ2位だったと思うんだけど、それからだんだんだんだん上がっていくっていうのは頭の中でどうやって考えてました。いや、もう正直クロエには勝てないと思ってたので、最後のがすごい練習もやってなくて乗れて、もうびっくりです。 So to be honest, she didn't think she was going to win. So and the last trick she did was she didn't even practice. So she was actually surprised right now.
Well, congratulations and good luck for the rest of the tour.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sam. There's your winner, Liz Akama. Great skateboarding all weekend, not just from her and taking that first place position, but women's skateboarding did so good today.
Wow. Everybody won. Skateboarding won today. Skateboarding won today. I'll tell you that much.
This is our top three. Yumika Oda in third place. Oh, we just missed that nollie flip that we wanted to see. Solid skateboarding, and look at that.
Flick for days, boy. Yeah.
And I mean, having a kickflip like that opens up all of those tricks, doesn't
it? Yeah, because you watch, you'll see it. Kickflip back 502.
So second place is the very, very powerful Chloe Covell. Man. There's that front side 180 ollie down to set up for the switch front board. So much style on
she
that.
She skated so good. Like
proper popped court switch flip, mid-run or end of run. There's the way it started off with that big kickflip. And I think that was the turning point for her. She was like, boom, it's on.
Yep.
And then this, I don't think I've heard a crowd scream so loud in my life at a skateboarding event. And here we have first place and our winner, Liz Akama from Japan. Smashed it on that hover. There's that front 180 switch Smith grind. And that front side feeble, front side 180 out. We said that was so awkward earlier. And all the power in the final hour, getting that done.
Wow.
Just great. And to stay that composed, knowing that it was that or nothing, was, you know, just great to see.
She didn't even practice it.
Yeah.
It goes to show the confidence, the confidence. Yeah. Wow, it's beautiful to see.
So
beautiful to be here.
That is going to be it for our women's finals. Manny, thank you very much for being here. And you're going to stick with me as we go through to our men's.
Yes. It's going to be crazy. I'm going to start yelling. Oh, man. I'm excited. I'm excited for this.
Yeah. It's electric, the atmosphere out there. And it's going to continue. We've got our men's finals coming up in approximately 15 minutes. Great to see some of the highlights there from that. Really wanted Momiji to finish higher in the pack, but sometimes skateboarding will let you know that you're not in control the full time.
100%. And that's why it's like, even when you're up, remember what I told, first thing I told you is I said it's not over until the end.
And that's exactly what we saw.
And with Chloe being so high up there and doing the 50-50 kickflip, and if you know, if she would have done the frontside flip, maybe she would have won. But it's not what she, what if, it's what you're in control of. And Liz was in control of that front people 180. She did it for the crowd, she did it for her country, she did it here in Rome, and it was amazing to witness.
So let's step away a little bit from the competition and chat about skateboarding in general. Skateboarding is a new addition to the Olympics, and these competitions are a new facet in the world of skateboarding. Manny, what have you seen and what changes have you noticed since these competitions have started?
Well, one thing I've noticed, and especially what's happening in Puerto Rico, in my country, is that parents are now supporting the kids that skate. They're helping them out. They're taking them to skate camps. They're bringing them to skate park. They're going by my skate shop, skate hop. And another very important thing is skaters who reconnect with their countries are now going back to their country and digging back into the roots of like why they look the way they look, or why they feel the way, and connecting with where they're from. And to me, that's the gold medal, is you going back to your country and feeling like at home and having that piece of a belonging.
Yeah.
And that to me, those two things are very important. And yeah, outside of that, just everybody skating and having a great time. But those two things are very important for the culture of skating and for the human race.
Yeah, 100%, 100%. Great words there, mate. And I mean, I've seen an explosion of women skateboarding, more women skating.
Oh, yeah.
And just the level of skateboarding going so, so high. An event of this scale, you wouldn't see other Olympic sports taking it to the streets and revisiting its humble beginnings. And skateboarding is very different than most other sports. So what did you do when you weren't competing out here in Rome?
If I'm going to be blunt, I got up today at 5 in the morning and went to the skate park at 7 a.m. to go skate because I didn't skate so well. So what I did was just go back to work.
Amazing.
And have a lot of pasta. That's it.
Yeah, and it's warm at that time out here as well.
Yeah, yeah.
And even though this competition's going on, there are still people out in the streets of Rome shredding, and even more so on Wednesday for Go Skateboarding Day.
To me, the Go Skateboarding Day is a celebration of all the homies just like getting together and skating and celebrating the sport, supporting each other, supporting the craft. And yeah, having fun.
Worldwide, it's official like Skateboarding Day. Everywhere in the world, they're gonna like celebrate Skateboarding Day. And it's on the 21st of June, summer solstice.
A day of fun, a day of skateboarding. Everybody meet at the spot, you can see. Skating, have the best tricks. But for me, you can skate every day. Not just for the Go Skateboarding Day.
So today we started from Piazza Venezia, that is a center like square. Then we went to Arapaci's, then to Pincio, downhill, skate shop and Ponte.
Skateare in una città come Roma e con tutte queste persone è bellissimo, cioè perché ci sono le persone che ti gasano, ti aiutano, ti filmano e anche la città comunque dà delle ambientazioni che sono bellissime.
Maybe the scene in Rome was one of the best in Italy.
I started in 91 in Castelli Romani. That's the suburbs in Rome, and everything is completely different. Back in the days, there's a main spot in Rome called Palombini, and Eur. That's this neighborhood called Eur, and that's the main spot in Rome. Like everybody go there from all over the city, Rome. All the skaters from different neighborhoods. Probably maximum 200 people. Today is like huge. Everybody skates. These days, like your parents push you to skate. In my era, it's impossible. My parents hate skateboarding.
Things changed a lot in the past 2 years. A lot of kids starting skate, a lot of grown men starting skate here in Rome. And it is a strange situation, but why not? There is more accessibility to that world, so more people can join.
So Ponte is a DIY skate park, and before it was just like nothing, a piece of land that was unowned, and skaters came and started like building shit here, like the ledges and the quarter, and that pyramid we built like last year, which was super fun.
Black ground was good. Space was enough. People said, oh, it's a nice place to skate. And we built it all together with like the skate community in Rome. And yeah, like since 12 years, it's like this.
Our community is strong. Skateboarding is so difficult when you are alone. Because many people don't like it, but when you are with skater and the gas go up, like everything becomes better.
I love the community and the skate scene here. I think community is super important in skating, even though it's an individual sport. Like you really like get the hype and like you know that energy from being around other skaters and to see each other grow in their own like craft, but it's something we all can do together.
Local, yeah, that's really fun. No ego. Oh, everybody's so friendly.
It was like 8 p.m. and I was still awake from being jet lagged, so I was like, oh, I kind of want to go skate some more, and I went and met some friends over there. I always like skating with the kids, skating with fans, and just hanging out and having a good time. I feel like that's just a big part of being a skateboarder. So shout out to everyone yesterday in Rome and the whole skate community in Rome. You guys are sick.
Rome, seriously, let's not play. Like skateboarding scene is big. Make skate parks, because if you want to make something for younger generations, do it.
Great to hear from everyone there. Go Skateboarding Day is 21st of June every year, and it's so good. Everybody comes out, and it's good to see that Nyjah got involved as well.
Yeah, that was cool. He usually, you know, he keeps to himself, and, you know, he's very famous, so he's got to be careful where he goes. And for him just to go there and just be like another one of those kids, that, as he is, it's beautiful to see it.
I went down there earlier today with DJ Redbeard. We had a good session. It was super hot. And the atmosphere down at that spot, it's like that every day. It's not just Go Skateboarding Day.
No,
everybody's like got such a good vibe. And, you know, it's that atmosphere that, you know, sets skateboarding apart from a lot of those other sports.
100%. It's a vibe.
So we're almost ready to get our men's final started. But before we do, we caught up with some of the biggest names out here to talk about skateboarding at this competition.
Bit when it comes to a big contest like the Olympics, or I mean really any contest, when you have the type of mindset that I do, I'm always hard on myself. I always put pressure on myself.
First of all, I just want to have fun. In last year I got third place in Rome and then in Sarja second, so we'll see I can get the first. That way it's 3-2-1. For me, competing on the qualifiers, quarterfinals, or even on the finals, I feel always pressure. Every time I go, I make finals, I just try to breathe deeply, just try to close my eyes, disconnect the world, and just think that I've been practiced for this moment, and this is the moment, and just try to do the best that I can to see if I can get the first place.
Last time I was here, 2021, made the team. That was just catastrophic and amazing and a roller coaster of emotions. I'm looking forward to having this contest be more steady water, but again, I'm really excited. In Sharjah, I was one trick away from winning street. Kind of keep that in my back pocket, knowing that when I go back there, I'll be able to have a fighting chance of winning. So going into this one, I'm looking forward to being a real threat and hopefully taking home the gold.
I'm very happy to be in Rome. I'm very exciting. Just having fun skateboarding.
Yeah, last year I got second, and that was a great moment for me, so I was super happy of that. So yeah, I can't wait to see what this year is going to happen. Oh yeah, I remember this moment for sure, because like that was one of the greatest I ever had. I'm really happy of that, and like I really want to say thank you to the people who support me for the skateboarding and like for Paris 24 and for all the riders competing. It's going to be like a crazy moment for all eyes going to be on skateboarding, because like I think it's the first sport going out of Seoul.
There's so many of these guys that are good now. So many of these young guys just doing the craziest tricks like Jinwoo. Most of my friends back home are more street skaters. I'm just out getting clips and hitting the streets with them. But yeah, it's crazy. Literally every year you come to the contest like this and you just see at least a few new people that are just absolutely killing it. So.
Jin is amazing. He's gonna be like one of the greatest skaters probably. And I respect him a lot. But right now I'm just trying to focus on myself.
Jinwoo is like a really, really good skateboarder. He's pretty young. He got the world's life in front of him. So I think he's going to be better and better like in the next couple of years, because like he's going to grow up, getting some pop and getting more tricks. So yeah, for sure, he's going to be one of the greatest skateboarders we've never seen.
I like this park, Rome Park. Every competition, all the time, I will do my best. I love skateboarding. And I love other skateboarders.
So great to get a little insight from those guys about the competition. And another part of the competition that we haven't yet mentioned is our judges. We've got some of the biggest names and very accomplished skateboarders themselves out there judging our skaters today. So head judge Garrett Hill. And then we've mentioned Vanessa Torres in our women's competition. Amy Massey, Danny LeBron in there, JP as well. Such a varied judging panel today.
Yes. They can all do a lot of tricks.
And speaking of judges, it's time to throw it down to the third member of our team who is on the course to find out more.
So Garrett, one of the head judges, hello, welcome. Could you please tell us what kind of prep work do you put into obviously coming along and being a judge here?
Yeah, it's a good question. All of the judges have been doing months of prep work leading up to any Olympic qualifying event. So obviously this is a really big deal. So we're watching all the other contests that are happening in skateboarding. We're referencing previous contests that have been World Skate Contests to make sure that the trick scores that we're giving out are in the same hemisphere of what has been given out before, just so that there's not like a wild card score that gets thrown out.
And so yesterday in semis, Gustavo had obviously done a couple of tray flip kind of variations of tricks, which looked super hard, but the judges scored them low. Can you just explain what happened there?
Yeah, sure. So there's a rule called the repetition rule, which really comes into play, especially when we get into the single trick section. And we saw it come into play yesterday. When a skateboarder does, especially a really difficult trick, multiple times, the repetition rule dictates that that score has to be docked a little bit. And it is up to the judges and the severity of the repetition that dictates how much that dock is going to be and how much that score is going to come down. Now, that doesn't mean you can't get a good score by repeating a trick. It just means you're going to get less than what you would have if you didn't repeat that trick. So in the case of Gustavo's trick, since that was such a killer trick, it was really, really tough, that score unfortunately had to come down.
And lastly, so obviously the street course has got different variations in it. You've got people like Nyjah and Jinwoo hitting every obstacle, putting so many tricks in there. You know, how does that affect a run? And on top of that, we've got quarters. Does that affect it? We got some riders who drop in, do a trick on a rail, come out, they pop out their board. Could you kind of give us a kind of rounded answer on what and how that affects their scoring?
Yeah, sure. So overall impression is a big part of what that score is going to look like at the end of the run. And variety, and in the case of Nyjah and Jinwoo, they're able to pack in so many tricks, and Jagger also, because they utilize those quarter pipes. Like a core street skater, we'll call him a core street skater, who doesn't really utilize the quarter pipes as much because you don't see that out in the streets, is normally going to get around 8 tricks in a line. But say someone like Jagger or someone who utilizes the quarter pipes more, they're able to stack in 12, 13 tricks, which significantly increases the score. So someone who can do a quarter pipe trick, instead of just getting off of their board, turning around, which also burns about 2 to 3 seconds, they're going to just watch that score increase.
Perfect. Well, that is everything from us, and back over to you guys.
Thank you very much, Sam. Great to hear some insights from Garrett there. And it is very nearly time that we get going. But let's check out our men's start list. We'll be kicking it off with Cordano Russell, someone who really stood out yesterday, absolutely smashed it. And it was Felipe Day yesterday, Manny, I'd say.
Oh, 100%.
He was on it.
Yeah, he has some of the hardest technical tricks out there.
Yeah, and first place qualifier through the very, very powerful Aurelien Giraud. And he wasn't messing around yesterday. I think he knew he had to put down that level of trick to get through today because everyone else stepped it up, not just from qualifiers and then into semis. It was crazy.
Yeah, but also Cardano comes from the Jagger school. He skates down in Encinitas, and he's been watching us for a very long time, waiting for his chance. So this is not like a yesterday thing. Like, Cardano's been watching for quite some time and waiting for this moment, and he capitalized.
Yeah, and I mean, he knows what it takes then. Sitting and watching closely, it's like, 100%. Okay, I need to do these kind of tricks. And how important is it that you do different tricks than anyone else is doing out there?
Yeah, it's important to do different tricks, important to be yourself. Also, there is a fine line that we walk with in tricks that we do. So Cordano has a different bag, and we'll see how the judges feel about that.
Okay. Let's get to Canada. We have run 1 of 2 for Cordano Russell. This is how we're stepping it up. Wow, fakey backflip down the rail. Wow. That's a way to start things.
That is a thing of beauty. That rail is not short. It's very long.
Yeah, and taking the 50-50 up the biggest hubber in the whole place. That certainly is something no one else is doing out there.
Yep, straight into the fakey 50. Make the switch back tail.
What's interesting, he was down at the DIY spot earlier today, and I've seen him just rattling off these tricks, but on just the ledge.
Yeah.
So he's just visualizing and getting that confidence that you know exactly where you are and that you can do it every time.
No, he knows what he needs to do. He's a student.
And that was certainly one of them that he did every go. Yeah. 360 flip, 50-50.
Yeah.
Great first run there for Cordano Russell.
And that is now saying to everyone else in the heat, check this out.
Yep.
What do you got for me?
Yeah, 100%. He just literally, he set the pace. The big spin front board didn't count, but he tried to squeeze it in there. But it didn't matter because he landed a lot of other things. If, like how Garrett was saying, if he would have squeezed in that big spin front board, that would have been one more big trick he could have added to how many he really would have done. But that coming off his board on the quarter pipe definitely took some seconds away.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the thing. You know, you might lose 2 seconds, but that means you can't get to that last trick.
Yes.
But great composure. He came back through. I don't think he's going to get much. I don't think it was a slam passe. Like, there you go. The score coming in, 75.74. And, I mean, we mentioned it in the women's earlier. We're seeing tricks that you would see as single tricks in runs now.
Yeah, 100%. The crowd's not so happy with that score.
So each skater gets 2 45-second runs, followed up by 5 tricks anywhere on the course. We have to take 1 score through from run section and 2 scores through from those tricks. Someone who knows this format very well is our next skater dropping in, Kelvin Hoffler from Brazil. Kick flip front 50-50 to start things off.
Whoa.
Kelvin's been smashing it for so long.
No, he's a veteran. He's a veteran in this. And
I don't know how he got away with that. Nearly Primo slid across the rail.
It's that's his inner confidence of contest. Like all the things he's been through, all the tricks he's had to endure, and look, he's done so many tricks already. he knows.
Still 10 seconds to go.
Yeah, he knows. If anybody knows what tricks they have to do, Kelvin knows what tricks he has to do.
Yeah, and we've really seen this run section step up from semifinals yesterday. That is going to be a heavy score.
That's the first switch tail 270 I've seen, unless he did it yesterday, but I haven't seen that.
I haven't seen that one yet, unless I was totally not paying any attention. Kickflip frontside 50-50. That's the way to start things off. You've got that confidence boost, but that's a high-risk way to start your run.
Yeah, 100%.
That switch frontside tailside 270.
You got to take those risks to get those rewards. Flipping your board a lot is very difficult. Also, stamina for your muscle. Think about flipping into every grind.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
that's why he gets
84.88 coming through, and that's a very comfortable score to be sitting on as you move through to that second run. That really lets you have a little bit more freedom to be able to try and step up. But can Kelvin step that run up?
Oh yeah, I've seen him do some crazy stuff in my day. Let me tell you what.
And talking about crazy stuff, Felipe Gustavo landed pretty much everything he tried yesterday.
Starting with the hardest trick.
Yeah.
Out of all the runs, that combination right there, he makes it look so simple, but it is very difficult to A nollie flip gap 50 and then kick from crooked double set rail.
Yeah, Felipe is literally so precise and accurate. And he's got access, because of that precision and accuracy, to tricks that no one else has, right?
Yeah, 100%. He has the power and the strength and power to do all these flipping, flip out, flipping, switch, nollie, like he's showing you right here.
Yeah, exactly. Wow.
Oh.
Just coming off of that. He really needs to get that switch back to tail side going. We saw it yesterday. And to be putting that combination of tricks together, kicking it off with a nollie flip 50-50. This is where it started.
Yeah, thing of beauty.
Great catch.
Look how calm he is. And then straight into a kickflip crook. Think of that combination.
Yeah.
Nollie flip gap 50, and then kickflip crook, the rail that no one else is kind of kickflipping, and they're just doing hurricane or basement from board. He has that power, that finesse, that skill. And he just makes it look too easy. That's what it is. He makes it look way too easy.
And do you know what? 71.21 coming through with a fall.
Yeah, he ain't mad at that.
That's heavy.
Switch back tail. He's definitely going to get 85. Ooh.
So we're going round to run 1 of 2 for Jagger Eaton. Current Park World Champion. We heard from his coach yesterday. Jagger's going for 2 golds, Manny.
Yeah, 100%.
Imagine that.
I was telling Jagger not too long ago, he's a once in a generation type of skater, and he's gonna make it so kids believe that they can be the best in park and street. There has yet to be one person to do that, and if anybody has the possibilities of doing that, of winning an event, which he almost did in Sharjah. He almost won the street and then won the park.
Yeah.
No one else could do that. He can.
He can. And so, I mean, that is going to breed a whole new generation of skaters, like you say.
Yeah, he represents the idea that you can do all that.
So like not that. Quite getting the run he wanted. And that one, that switch frontside nose grind, was after time. But,
oh, he'll be back.
You know, as soon as you don't quite get something, he saw him fall on the switch feeble. So that's how things started.
That's what shook up the basket, as they say.
Yeah, and I mean, we spoke about it earlier. You know, if you don't land something as perfect as you usually do, it can really throw the rhythm of your run.
100%. Because now he's thinking for his next run, when I do switch back lip, I hope that doesn't happen again.
Exactly.
And he's
someone who has the confidence to just come back heavy hitting is him.
He's injecting that idea.
Great scenes here. There's the Colosseum just on the left. Amazing history out here in Rome. Such a historic, special place, and I think history is going to be made again today.
Yes, sir.
Glass skateboarding, that's a way to start your run for sure. Switch frontside tailside, 360 flip. And this is the thing that sets Nyjah apart. Kickflip backside disaster. I mean,
always.
You saw Jagger's last run. He's someone who will do all of those tricks as well on the quarter pipes. He knows how important it is. And that could be the trick that sets you apart from first and second place, right?
Yeah, 100%. All those little ticking and tacking over here and there and there and there, that adds up points, like Garrett said. And if that's how they're judging and that's what they're looking at, guess what? Nyjah is the type of skater that if he hears that and knows that, he will change his whole game plan. I've seen it happen in person.
Yeah, and on the fly as well. Just, you know, next run, change it up from what you've seen him do before. Hats off to him on that one. That was incredible.
That was amazing.
And I mean, we saw that yesterday. People were doing that in the trick section. I keep coming back to it.
Yeah.
We're seeing that mid-run, and it's people like Nyjah who are pushing that level.
Yeah.
He's saying, you know what? You're going to do that in your trick section. I'm doing it in my run.
Yeah, because he knows.
So what have you got for me?
His bag is so deep that he's able to implement those tricks in his run. Like that half-cap backspin back 180 to him is like doing a back tail. Like he practices that much to have those tricks that easy. And not only that, he's coming back from an ACL surgery. This is his second contest back.
Yeah, that was what I was going to mention. You know,
like, he's happy.
It wasn't that long ago.
Yeah.
A little while ago, and he's already back and getting a 9 on the board already.
Yeah.
90 coming through.
That's what he does. You gotta give him his roses. That's what I tell people. You gotta give Nyjah his roses. We have to appreciate him while we have him active.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, so well put.
That's like when Jordan was playing, or what they do to LeBron sometimes. They try to bring him down. Like, bro, like you understand? Like these people are like they work so hard to give you a show. Like, let's not wait till after to be like, oh yeah, he was so good.
Yeah, let's appreciate him right now.
Yeah, like how we appreciate Gustavo when he flips in out of crooks and Trey from Nova Nolly flip. Like, this thing of beauty. Look at right here.
Speaking of a thing of beauty, Gustavo Ribeiro stepping it up from his runs yesterday, and it's someone who has got a deep bag and can really, really change up his runs on the fly as well.
100%. He's also adapted the tricks on everything, try to have multiple tricks.
And it's things like that we saw yesterday, and it was pretty much every go. It was like he couldn't fall off. Crooked grind, only flip out. Yeah. And I mean, that long rail, he's taken advantage of that time to be able to get that foot ready. But, you know, we know he's got really fast feet.
Oh,
he can
360
flip into a nose blunt slide and do tricks out of it. And that is what we're probably going to see 100%. As we go through to best tricks.
He has the, I told him in his jar park, he did tray flip, nose blunt, big spin on the uni rail. He has to date the techiest trick on a handrail.
Yeah.
Like, and when I told him that, he was like, didn't understand. He was like, wait. And I'm like, yeah, bro, you did trick in a little bit. Like, that's the techiest trick on an actual hitter on the streets, dog. Not in a skate park, not when it's nice and smooth, like in the streets.
Yeah. Like, I mean, that tells you something for sure.
Yes,
as
sir.
We wait for that first run score to come through. He's going to be disappointed to not get that, but 77.22 with a full, Manny.
Yeah.
That's what we're talking about.
Yep.
The rest of the run was, you know, what we would have seen for a full run not that long ago.
Mm-hmm. If that.
Yeah, exactly. So with a bag of possibly the most difficult, awkward blind tricks, just like that one right there. Sora Shirai,
yes, sir.
Run number one of two.
Yep. Notice how he didn't go for the big spin. He wants to get a good solid scoring before he tries to do that super run.
We're going
to
call them super runs.
Yeah. I mean, that's what we're looking at, super runs. So 23 seconds on the clock as he come in to that long rail, point in that backside Smith grind all the way through. You see that front toe holding it in place.
Beautiful tray flip.
So coming down.
Oh wow.
That's unexpected. Yes. And I mean, you can hear the crowd. They're like, whoa.
Yeah, and it's because of the pressure Nyjah put on. He set the precedent. Remember, I told you, first person to set the precedent always makes everybody else crumble.
Yeah. And I mean,
either you rise or you crumble.
Yeah. Nyjah just put a cat amongst the pigeons right now. He's okay.
Yeah. He's like, oh, yeah, really? And you won Charizard? Well, guess what? I won Rome last time. I'm not trying to let you have it.
This is my place. Welcome to my house.
Yeah, I'm the gladiator.
Yeah. So that was a great recovery from Sora. Those tricks, his trick choice, you know, you mentioned it earlier in the women's. Team Japan are like, okay, everybody's doing these tricks.
Yeah.
What else is there? Yeah. What can we choose? Yeah. And it's interesting to see them sort of changing up the traditional tricks that you see in a competition.
100%. It's cool. And I believe in that there's a secret. They take salsa, especially Puerto Rican Spanish salsa classes when they're babies, so that when they're swinging their hips back and forth, it's just like they're dancing.
It's all in the rhythm. So 78 coming through there.
Uh-oh. The local hero.
Okay.
This is the one that got away.
We go back to the top of the heat. It's Aurelien Giraud, run one of two.
Yes, sir. Yep.
Looking solid out there. And that's, you know, you see the way he pushed up the quarter pipe then?
And then pumped
every millisecond counts when it comes down to the finals.
Yes. He knows. He's not even from Rome, and he's the local hero. Imagine that. For what he did last year.
Adopted son.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Big 360 flip. And, I mean, that's that power that we know is coming, but it's the consistency of that 360 flip.
Yep.
We mentioned it earlier. Every time that the board leaves your feet is risk. It really is.
His coach.
Yeah, Alexis Jean.
He stood right there for that reason, I believe. Because that's not the first time. That's not the first time the hard flip front board got away from him. Last year, he would hard flip on board, and in between all the qualifiers, his board would shoot exactly in that direction.
Yeah.
So they prepped. They prepped for the board throwback.
Yeah. I'm here. I'm surprised he didn't have the spare there to just throw back in.
Imagine.
Boom. There you go. You're back in the game. And I mean, what I think's just happened. And I mean, I don't know, because Aurelien's so confident. Not much gets in his brain. But what we saw from Nyjah, you know, is he now thinking, okay. And do you think that he maybe changed some of the tricks in his run?
Yeah, well, he knows he has a super upgrade so he can detach himself from Nyjah because he knows what Nyjah's going to do. But also, the only times I've seen Aurelien get that where he's huffing and puffing or kind of show a little bit of chink in his armor, no pun intended, is when Nyjah or Yuto or someone does like a run where he knows he has to super overscore it.
Yeah.
So, guess what?
Wow, we are into runs number two. Cordano back in and changing up that run. We mentioned it earlier about how important it is to change your run up, and the judges are really rewarding people who do. And that's something that I think if this whole run gets put together, this score is going to go through the roof. We saw him fall off on the first run just getting up the quarter pipe, so he's already past that point now. Yeah.
No, he's good now. He's focused. He's composed. He did a super upgrade, switched that trick because he did the nollie big spin last time, lip slide, and that's where, you know why? That's that rushing on the course.
And obviously pumping really hard to get that speed.
Yep.
Oh, so gutted.
It's sad to see.
Imagine just chucking that in like that. I mean, you know, when you're on that level of skateboarding and everything's happening.
Yeah, it's sad to see, but that's what happens when you're... He took his attention away from the quarter pipe to try to get speed looking back at the hubba. Like, look, when he turns, they'll show it. When he turns, he like lost attention from his board. And in that split second, the pump
yeah, just slipped out. I mean, it is slippery up there. We've seen people falling over going up the flat bank. And something that's worth mentioning, we heard from him earlier, we've not got Jim Wu in the final. And I think he might well have been in there. We saw the kickflip backside tail slide shove.
Yeah.
And he celebrated, and it threw him off.
Yep.
You know,
and that's something, you know, I don't like to, you know, I don't like, I'm never one to try to, like, say people do things wrong or, like, especially in at the level that we're at. But the Japanese team and a lot of the Japanese skaters, even in the contests in Japan, as soon as they land a trick, and I get it, it's an emotional moment, but as soon as they land a trick, and it happened with the girls, they stand up and put their hands up.
Yeah.
They're taking focus away from the right away, and the best part about skateboarding when you do a trick is what? The right away.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's sad. We need, there needs to be maybe a conversation had, or maybe like, hey, as you're skating over to us, hands up. You know,
because just, they're doing, just make sure you've landed it before you celebrate.
Look at kickflip nose. Wow. What did I tell you about Calvin?
We said, is he going to upgrade? What, and he certainly has on that first trick. Kickflip frontside nose grind. Not sure if he got that back truck on, though.
There we go.
Okay.
Front blunt,
25 on the clock. Backside tail slide, stepping down. That looked like it felt really nice.
All that. And this is him saying, like, oh, you guys didn't want to give me, you didn't want to give me the 90 for my first run. I'm going to do kick for front nose run, completely bolts.
So I think he was trying to get that frontside nollie switch feeble 180 out, and then thrown him a little bit, but came back in with
Joe
that as well.
Wow. No, he
Oh, my God. Can we get a medical team up here in the booth? Man, he's just lost it.
Oh, man. Hey, I think he did nollie lip fakie on purpose because he wasn't set up in time. Because it was...
Oh, okay, so played it safe.
Yes, because he knew, all right, kick flip nose grind. But, hey, the judges are watching. And he did tray flip lip. That's an upgrade. He has this
upgrading
thing
upgrading on what we've already seen is so special.
Yeah. Look at him. Fun.
Yeah. The bonus in there as well.
Yeah, 100%. Calvin, look at him.
So 84.88 already on the board.
Yep.
Whoa, okay, 91.51. It didn't hurt.
No.
He just did the nollie lip and he was like, okay, I need to stay on. And I mean, if you want to upgrade from the 84.88, that's what you've got to do. You can't fall.
Yeah, because he swapped the two bump to rail tricks.
And I mean, that's tantamount to how educated Kelvin is in competitions as well. We saw it yesterday. He went for one trick, didn't get what he wanted, and he came back and said, no, I'm X-ing out of that one.
Yeah.
I'm going to take that roll to be able to scratch one trick and come back without the repetition roll hurting it.
100%.
So Felipe Gustavo back in, missing that nollie flip 50-50.
That's the hard part about trying a risky trick on the big section for your first trick.
Yeah,
it happens.
I mean, you can see it there. It's affecting that rhythm. It's affecting that confidence.
Yeah.
But, wow, one of the best frontside flips in the game, I'd say.
Yeah. No, it's beautiful.
Coming in.
Yep.
Switch. Saw him trying that in practice, and I was thinking, is that going to go in and run, or is it going to go in on trick section? But when you know you're not going to be able to upgrade on your last run, you can use that time. Have a couple little practice goes at something.
Yeah.
You know, sneak a couple in. You know, maybe try something out, see how you're feeling. Because if you're not going to make that run, you might as well conserve your energy and maybe have a go at something else.
100%.
So someone who didn't make their first run is Jagger Eaton up next. Currently in seventh. He's going to want to step it up. So starting it where it went before.
He's going to scratch it.
You can see in his face there, currently in seventh. That's going to put a lot of pressure on the trick section. But he's got some of the biggest tricks to do in that section on the course.
You know what caused that? What caused that bail? Was he thought, remember I told you he thought about it too much. I hope this doesn't happen again.
Yeah, I was going to say, maybe those whispers in your ear that you can sometimes not ignore were coming into play there.
Yeah.
You can see the disappointment.
Yeah, he works really hard. He works really hard for every inch that he does of tricks. He works twice as hard. He trains for park and he trains for this.
Yeah.
So kudos.
Yeah, he's working twice as hard as anyone out there. And I think you saw on that switch backside lip slide that front truck just getting caught up nearly. And that's something that's going to really put the frighteners on you. It's going to be like, oh, and then that can change everything.
He could still fight for a good top four spot. Depending how everything goes, he could fight for the from four to eight. So there, that's, remember, long game.
Yeah, long game.
When things like that happen, switch to the long plan. Yeah. What's the long plan? All right, let's try to get as high as we can. Now Nyjah's just going to show off and do what he does well.
Yeah, but he's going to want to get back into that first place position as we go through to tricks. Whoa, hanging in there. He's smiling. He knows he's lucky to get away from that. But that could change things up as well. Sometimes you're like, you need to mess something up before the hard trick that you're trying to be able to get that hard trick in. And, you know, it's not knocked him, and that shows just what an amazing competitor that Nyjah is. I love this combo as well. Oh, no, he's changing it up. I like the half cab flip and the backside flip, but changing it up. Fakie flip, cab flip.
Yeah, 100%.
5 seconds on the clock. Oh, not getting the dip of the truck. And he's laughing to himself out there. He knows he's in a good position. Yes. 1.51 behind. And, you know, to be laughing after taking that kind of a slam is it's special.
Yeah. He just you know what? He's happy to be out here. This is all, this is what he loves. He looks forward to this stuff. This has been his life. He has that life outside of, you know, competing and stuff. And he likes riding dirt bikes and hanging out with his friends and filming. But, like, where he feels the most alive, and I promise you, is slowly taking everything that you do good so that he can look great.
Yeah.
Like, it's his competitive edge.
Yeah, and I mean, it's that competitive edge that will change it up, but it also plays on everyone else's mind.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
He knows that other people are going, they're worried. Yeah. They're worried about me.
Yeah, he knows.
So, someone else to be worried about. Gustavo Ribeiro dropping in. Going to really want to get this down. That front foot catch there.
Beautiful.
Not Jason Lee approved, but hey, nonetheless.
No, yeah, facts. Not Kalis approved either.
No.
But it's, you know what? It's Gustavo approved, because he'll do it into nose blunt and ollie flip. So at that point, it is what it is.
I mean, Eric Kupecki back in the day doing that front foot catch on the 360 flips. Oof. So unusual to not see Gustavo making that one.
Yeah.
Especially, and that's really thrown him.
Especially a trick with nose blunt. Yeah, weird to say.
That's his trick.
Weird to not see him land a trick with nose blunt on the most mellow, sketchy double set rail.
Yeah, I can't believe what I'm saying there. That's nuts. I mean, that double set is long, it's low, and that rail isn't the smallest rail, is it?
Yeah, it's not. It's not at all. It seems like the way it's shaking out, it might be, depending on what Aurelian does, it might be a three-person showdown, or sorry, Sora as well.
Yeah,
it's looking like it's shaking to be a handful of people showdown.
Once again, though,
you never know till it's over.
Sora Shirai coming in, frontside tail slide down. Oh, okay, so solid on that trick. I'm blown away about how you can have that as a trick that you can do every time.
Yeah, it don't make sense. Only person I knew that had that trick like that was Gailea Mamalu.
Yes.
And Cody McIntyre.
Yeah,
like, into
for
back
sure.
tail. But I wouldn't say they even had it that as good as that.
Okay, oh, so, we're seeing some crazy stuff happen in our finals. He's going to call that one.
I'm telling you.
Currently in third, he kind of has a little bit of room to be able to throw the runaway, but you can't be that comfortable.
That's that Nyjah and Kelvin constant battle pressure that they put on everyone. With them two on the course, or just as yourself, you got to completely not care that there's like that they are on the course. You have to be like, oh, they're... You got to look at them as like, oh, yeah, whatevs.
Yeah.
Like, boys, we're out here. But you can't go, no, he got a 90. I need a 90. That's where it happens. You don't need a 90. All you need is an 87, 88.
Exactly, yeah.
So that you can go, okay, here's my single that'll get a little bit more than yours.
Yeah.
Here's another one that'll get a little bit more than yours.
Exactly. And it's that long game you're talking about as well. So currently sat on the 61 for run number one. He needs a full solid run. And exactly what you say, it needs to be up there in the 80s. If he is in for a chance to get podium.
Oh,
that's going to knock it.
Yep.
But if he hustles like he is right now, there's a possibility to get up there in the mid to late sevens.
If he does
maybe an 80.
If he does two crazy tricks.
Yeah.
Like, if he does one of his banger, bangers in the big section that he's going to have to do.
And there's one of them.
he can definitely get a low 80. If he does that bigger flip or a back three kick flip, if he does back three kick flip or bigger flip right now,
he's going to need to do that.
He'll get an 80.
Okay, Aurelia, run number two. We're going to see it. No, we're not. And you can see the disappointment on his face there. He knew just how important it was to get that last trick. And two falls in a run, it's going to be very, very difficult to come back from that. But he's got some of the biggest tricks to do still.
I wish they would have put a camera on Nyjah when Aurelian fell, so we could see the reaction, a cut reaction of Nyjah going like this. Yes. <laughs> Yeah, for sure.
And I mean, that's the thing. You want people to do well, but also
not
you
Nyjah.
Want to do well.
No, not Nyjah.
Nyjah's going that.
No, you're out.
You're done.
He don't play that. He don't play that friendly stuff on the
course. He's just ticked. Okay, that's one out of the way
that could be
an issue.
He is. He knows. He knows. And Aurelian knew he had to get into that 80, at least the 80.
For sure. Okay, let's check out that current leader run from Kelvin Hoffler. Kickflip nose grind.
Beautiful. Look at this. Beautiful.
Yeah, perfect landing. All the stees on the way out as well. That ride out you were talking about.
Switch 540.
Tail.
No, it's 540 out.
Yeah.
That's that Luan.
Reverting on the flat bottom.
So that's our current leader
as we move through to best trick section. Five tricks anywhere on the course. A lot of people are sticking with that middle hubba and the two long rails, right?
Yeah, 100%, because it's what's going to get the most points. It is the biggest obstacle on the course. Like, if you were to draw that hubba the size of the rail, it's the same thing as the rail, maybe even higher. So, and gapping into a hubba, you get lost in where you have to pop, and the judges know that. It's not easier because there's a gap to it. You know, it's not. Maybe for that switchback nose run, because you can go over the top. But for most tricks, if you're flipping in, the corner of the top of the hub, it tells you, get closer.
Yeah, it's camouflaging the rest of it.
Yeah.
Okay, it's time to throw it down to the third member of our team, Sam Bruce, who is down course side.
Hey, Adam. Hey, so let's talk about Cordano. He's a new name in the game. It's his first World Skate. What's his experience so far?
Oh, it's been incredible. He started out in the first heat, and he's basically fallen on almost his first runs and come in clutch. So we've just been able to do it every time and keep progressing his way through. So incredible to see. Such a great talent.
I mean, like you said, so he's one of the very few people who've been preceded. So he started off from heat one, going through all the days. I mean, has that taken a toll on him at all?
Well, it's been good. He's been building him the way up. The first heats, he was just basically running the park, just nobody else. But then as he got later on, he's skating with the big dogs, and it didn't faze him at all. He's been able to hold his own, show the world his tricks, and he's just, again, such a great kid. He's such an amazing athlete, so phenomenal to see him here.
And what's his plan for, you know, the next up-and-coming tricks?
Oh, I can't tell everybody that, can we now? But they're going to be really good. He's got something. He's a little bit different than everyone else, and he's going to show off his new bag. And, yeah, it's going to be exciting.
Amazing. Thank you so much for that. And back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Sam. Always good to hear that there's still some sneaky little tricks that we haven't seen yet in the tank.
I know. I know what everybody's going to try.
One standout trick yesterday was that half cab blunt slide pop over back lip.
Yep.
That was something special and something I didn't expect to see.
Yeah, I feel like he gets a lot of that practice skating Poots Park. So Poots Park has like a very low, long flat bar, and I'm sure he's done that there a million times. What about this scenario? What about this scenario? Nyjah goes for it and bails all five tricks.
Anything's possible. I mean, I doubt it, knowing what how good he is. I doubt it, but whoa! Okay.
Yep.
There's one we haven't seen before.
Yeah, it's a Nolly 270 shove. It's a different and random one. But he does it on stuff that you can't deny it.
Look at the foot position on that. Foot facing basically straight forward.
Yeah, you can't deny it. You can't deny that he did it on that. That is the most scariest thing that you could do.
I mean, there's one thing flipping in or, you know, shoving into a rail, but then to hold it for the length of this rail.
That was bonkers. That was 100%. going to get an... that should have got
a... Okay, 85.25. Looks like the judges liked it as well.
I would have gave that a 9, man. That was crazy.
We need to get you over there in the judges' booth.
No, because they have to judge me. I don't want no bad blood.
No, I think they're doing a great job there, and they've got probably the hardest job. No. I'm glad I'm in here with you
100%.
Doing this.
It's easier to talk about stuff than to judge it, I'll tell you that much.
Okay. Someone who's looking very comfortable at the moment. 91.51 on the board already from that run section. Kelvin Hoffler. What are we going to see?
Where is he coming?
It's interesting. Okay, he's over that side.
Oh.
Risky one.
Going for that sugar.
Yeah, I mean, that's a long rail to hold the sugar cane in, right?
Yeah, he also has... He broke his finger at Shajar in the finals and is dealing with a wrist injury, so there's a lot going on.
Yeah, for sure. And I mean, that's, you know, the high risk is high reward, like we keep saying.
Right.
But that's going to knock the confidence slightly because we've seen so much good stuff come out of him already.
Yeah, 100%.
I was expecting to see maybe an easier trick done first.
Oh!
Someone who's not doing any easy tricks now is Felipe Gustavo.
Oh my god.
We need
a button.
Roger's like, what?
Oh.
Wow. That was incredible. I think we might see one of the highest scores all weekend. Look at that. Nolly flip.
Wow.
Frontside nose slide.
That doesn't get any better. Look how he landed. Yeah, take that. Mm-hmm.
The way he held himself, because, you know, the way that trick can slip away and you end up, like, doing a fakey Superman out of it.
Bro.
I mean, he held on to that. Core strength. Wow.
Wow. Wow.
Look at him chilling. I'd be losing my mind right now.
Wow.
Oh, what have we got to come? 92.42. Yes. Great judging there. And jumping up into first place. Like you said, it's never over until it's over.
Yep. Man.
Felipe Gustavo has blown me away this whole weekend. And it is continuing through our finals. And dropping in after that, someone who can definitely hold his own. Jagger Eaton, trick number one of five.
Going for that backside flip and a nose grind. You can see it in his face. He seems a little down.
I think Jagger's got into his own head at the moment.
His energy his energy's low.
Yeah.
I mean,
you usually see he's the dude like, yo.
Yeah.
I mean, we get the Jagger swagger as he walks away.
Jagger swagger.
We see it. It's so good. And, like, you know, you see that confidence level that he has, which is what gives him the ability to do those tricks.
Yes, it's that self-belief. We gotta be more kind to ourselves out there. Oh, here he is.
Okay.
Switch heel tail.
Trick 1 of 5. Yeah. Switch heel tail. He's riding away, smiling, absolutely beaming.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's it's mad to say. That's relatively easy for him.
Yeah, 100%. But you know why? Because of all the work, I'm telling you.
Oh, he's done that trick how many times, you reckon, this weekend?
This weekend? I don't even know. I don't even know this week, but in just general, probably like, I don't know, 10,000 times.
Yeah. And I mean, that's what it takes to have that on lock and to have that in your pocket as one of the tricks. You know, it's all bought and paid for. He's got the receipt for it.
Yeah.
You know, it's
100%.
Like, oh, okay, I'm just going to churn that out.
Yeah.
And I mean, to be able to get that kind of score as well on the board and be sat there in that first place position, way up there. 182.55. It's looking great so far.
Gustavo. Wow.
Whoa. Okay, another person who's got a crazy trick on lock and on demand. Gustavo Ribeiro from Portugal. There's that nose grind.
He does this so
all the way through. He gets on high on that as well.
So good. Like,
boom.
Catches it. Comes down, is composed. He knows where he's at completely at every second of that moment.
Yeah.
Like.
And it's that front foot, the way that he gets the over into the pinch and holds it in place.
Yeah.
And then just adjusts the back foot. Yeah. And 90.22 coming in. 167.44 on the board, but still some work to do.
Yeah, I wish he was a little nicer to himself. He should have smiled a little bit. Yeah. He looked a little down, but I get it. He's very competitive too, you know?
Sora Shirai, trick one of five. Oh, that trick is so crazy. To picture myself trying that, it's completely blind. You don't know where you're at until you're at it.
Yeah.
He's
that guy. He's that guy. And then also, too, this is why the hubba is a lot scarier than people, like, keep forgetting. They're like, oh, it's a hubba. It's a gap to hubba. Like, the rails are long. But it's like, yeah, but that hubba is not. It's very unforgiving. Like, all of us.
Yeah.
If we don't get in right, a majority of us get slammed on it. Coco got taken out.
Yeah.
You know, like, it's, you know, it's intense. Let's see what Mr. Gerard got right there.
Yeah. Trick one of five.
Wow!
Okay, bit of a Baker Maker on that one.
Exit. Oh, he got off.
I think he stepped away. So, yeah. See the disappointment. That's one of his tricks that he's got in the bag. Zero score coming through. Yeah, judges saying, nah, you're not having that.
Yeah.
No way. Not at this point.
Right now, as of right now, tonight, Nyjah's living rent-free in Aurelian's head.
Yeah, in everybody's head, I think.
Yeah.
Or maybe Calvin. Not Cordano,
yeah.
Actually.
No.
He's doing his own thing.
Yeah, he don't even care.
He's like, yeah, whatever. I'm in the finals. Like,
yeah,
whatever. I'm just out here having fun now.
Yeah, I'm going to do these. Bomb, bomb. Wait.
Whoa.
Didn't he do that in his run?
Yeah, so that repetition rule is going to come in. But technically, do you think that was a land? Is that a make?
He rode away. He just rode away sloppy.
Yeah.
He did in his run, though, right?
But yeah. Okay. Maybe he was going to do something else out of it. I'm not sure. Or maybe going to go to fakie, but ended up just having the shoulders round and having to take it out forward again.
We'll see how the judges score.
Confusing, yeah.
Because he rode away. So technically, he rode away. The ramp is what... Like, he's there.
And we heard it from Garrett earlier. Someone doing a technical trick, and if they've done it in their run section already, they're going to get scored well for it, but just not quite as much as they could have got.
Yeah, probably like a 52 or something, which is crazy to say, or 60-something.
Yeah.
But he did right away.
Currently in fourth place. He's looking good. Okay, 80.77. Surprising. But he's going to be happy. 241.67 as we move through tricks number two. Kelvin yet to score in this section. I'm sure he's going to have a little sweep up around the front of the takeoff.
Yeah, 100%.
Classic scenes from Kelvin.
Yeah, takes his time.
But we all have those things that we do.
Yeah,
when we're
to.
Doing stuff,
it's
you
good.
Have
yeah.
like, you know, this kind of rhythm. And,
yeah.
and
you
when you're
routine.
In a familiar place, you yeah. can do familiar tricks.
You have your routine. Kick your board, throw your like board upside down.
Okay.
He's playing the
half
game.
Cap, backside Smith, 180 out.
Kelvin's playing the game.
But like we said earlier,
Nyjah did it in his run.
But it's not going to get scored like any less than just
no.
how good that trick
yeah.
is, though.
Yeah,
not for him, because he's not done that yet.
Yeah, true. It'll probably get like an 85, I want to say, maybe 82. Depending how the judges feel about it. He didn't do it. That was his first time.
But 84. I think what was good, not you know, boom, 84.82
yeah.
coming through.
That makes
and
sense.
He's playing that whole thing of, okay, the sugar cane didn't work out for me. Maybe it didn't feel as good as he thought it could be.
Yeah.
Stepping away from it
yeah.
and coming back to a different trick that he know he can do.
Yep.
Then he's got the ability to maybe go back to that.
Yeah.
And it's so important at this point to get those two scores on, because we can only take two scores from this section
yeah.
of the competition to go with that one score from the runs. Okay. I think Felipe is in that position with the 71.21. Not as high as he'd like to be in the run
yeah.
section, so he's throwing everything at it right now.
Yeah. Well, Nyjah just took a slam. Yeah, he's... If I was Felipe, I would throw that switch flip tail just to get that comfortable score and then try to go super upgrade. Because he just hurt his hip on that switch flip nose grind. Getting
so Jagger, trick attempt 2 of 5.
Is that Jagger swagger? Oh,
no, we're not going to see it.
Come on, Jagger.
3 attempts left. And at this point, he's just trying to finish as high as he can in the heat. Just to get that long game, you know, the higher you finish, the more points you get
yeah.
that go towards the big show, Paris 2024 Olympics. So, Nyjah Huston, trick attempt 2 of 5. Already got the 92.55. It's looking good, but he's got to hold it down.
Yeah, he's got to
build up on that cake.
Oh, he's building right here.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I mentioned it earlier. I saw him do that in practice. You could see his face as he rode away from it. That's going to be a huge score. And
yeah.
this is the Nyjah we've seen previous injury. Yeah. You know, he's come back as strong, maybe even stronger.
Yep.
Heel, switch frontside 5-0.
Yeah, he did that very good.
Oh, more than very good. Perfect, yeah. I'd say, pretty much.
A thing of beauty. See if they score that. That should be 90, 91, 92.
And I mean,
switch heel front 5-0 is not
anybody easy. Else going to do that out there?
No.
You know, and that's what sets him apart in the judges' eyes. It's like, well, who else is doing that? How can we not score that as colossal as we can?
Yeah, facts. 89.
Okay. I kind of thought that would be a bit higher myself, but at the same time.
You know what it is? They're using the repetition of the variation. So switch heel tail.
Yeah. Switch heel 5-0. We've already seen the switch heel.
Yeah. So that's for sure, because if not, it would have been higher than a switch heel tail.
For sure. Oh, was that going 180 out, or was that just an awkward catch? Because we know he's got 360 flip nose grind.
Yeah, he should have just done 360 flip nose grind to get a good score.
But as we said it, maybe Nyjah's getting in everybody's head and just, you know, okay, I can't just do my usual tricks. I've got to put a little sprinkle of special sauce on it.
Yeah, he should have done trick flip nose grind and then gone for the trick flip nose blunt nollie flip and then called it a night. Had some pasta.
I mean, but but this is the thing. Sometimes you drop in and you're just like, what am I doing?
Yeah, facts.
There we go.
Sara told you what he was doing.
He's going to be high to that little samurai swipe then.
He said, Rasengan.
Yeah. And this is going to really build up the confidence now for Sara.
Yeah, now he's having fun. He's back to having fun. Wow.
Such a crazy trick, that one. The sound effects going on as well now.
We got it all. What do you need?
Okay, no score yet in the trick section. 78.29 and 91.91 on the board.
Yeah.
That's going to be the confidence boost he needs.
Who's Cordano talking to?
Three more attempts.
He's over there talking to himself.
Okay, 65.47 and no score in the run section. Aurelien Giraud coming back. Trying to answer what we've seen from everyone else with the hard flip back to 180. Currently way down there at the bottom of the heap. So we're taking it back to the top of the heat. Trick attempts 3 of 5. We're hitting that midway point. And already on the board, we have an 85.25 and an 80.77. That's going together with the 75.74. Not as high as he'd like to have in that run section. Didn't quite get the runs that he wanted, but we're seeing crazy tricks from Cordano already.
Oh, have Kev Blunt to back.
Yeah, I think he was going to that back lip then. Still 2 attempts to go at that. And having 2 tricks on the board, we mentioned it earlier, that kind of opens up to try and upgrade those scores.
Yeah. He's just trying, at this point, he's trying to get as high. He can't win because Nyjah has 3 nines, but he's trying to get as high as he can to either get a podium or get as many points as he can. Because if everybody starts to crumble, he'll get podium. But if Gustavo does trade from nose grind, he'll jump on top. If Felipe Gustavo does switch from tail, he'll jump on top. So at this point, they just need to get a mid-8 to a low-8 just to even jump into second place.
Yeah, amazing.
I hope their coaches are doing...
Did you hear what you just said?
Yeah.
Nyjah's got 3 nines.
Yeah.
Already.
Yeah. He's special, man.
Yeah.
He's special, man. I take my hat to him every time.
3 scores available, and all 3 of them are 9s.
Yeah.
That's shocking, but expected at the same time, which is crazy.
Yeah, 100%. I don't expect him to perform any less. When he has a fluke performance, that's when it's like, whoa! But he's worked so hard for so long that, like Kelvin too, like they breathe this competitive field stuff.
Yeah, I mean, it was interesting there. We've seen Kelvin waxing his board up, because you're not actually allowed to wax any of the obstacles after the competition runs.
Yeah.
So he's put a bit of wax on that.
Oh.
Going for the Kelvin special there. Yeah, half cab nose slide, popping it round to the backside tail slide.
He went too fast. He needed to go a little slower.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, knowing that it's a gap out to a hubba, you're like, I need to go fast, surely.
I know. I'm over here talking. I got a mic. I'm not doing the trick, so I can at least say it.
But the thing is, with a half cab coming up fakie, you got to take off way earlier than you usually would.
Yeah, and like I said, the gap to Hubbard, there's a perspective that throws you off. So he thinks he has to go faster because of that Hubbard calling you saying, get closer.
So we're taking it back round to Felipe Gustavo, 92.42 already in this section, but 71.21. Still work to do, Manny.
He can do it. Oh, please somebody tell him to do switch flip tail. Somebody run down there, tell him switch flip tail.
Roger, jump in there.
If I show you my phone, I told him to do switch flip crook.
Oh, this morning. This is your fault.
Kinda. I said, bro, you got to switch real quick to Hubba at 9:44. Okay. This morning I sent him a message.
Trick 3 of 5 for Jagger Eaton.
Oh,
that's one of his tricks that he usually has no issue with. We saw it yesterday, first go.
It's that inner warrior mentality is taking a beating, and it's hard. It's hard. You have to be a special kind of person to be able to go switch and be like, nope, I'm not hearing you. I'm going to land it right here.
Yeah, exactly.
By the way, you walked away, you talked away, you carry your face. Your facial expression says a lot. Look at Nyjah. Look at his face.
So 90.
He's laughing.
92.55, 89.92, just off that 90 that we were speaking about. But that would definitely upgrade it.
Yeah, now he'll backtail fakie. If he does that, it might seal the deal. Once again, though, it's not over till it's over.
Nah, Liz proved crowd getting behind him there as well.
Liz proved me wrong.
So, currently in fifth place. Pressure is starting to mount for Gustavo Ribeiro. There you go. Okay, he didn't mean to do the 180 out before, and he's listening to you. Maybe he just quickly tuned in, rewound it, and went, just do the straight nose grind.
He's listening to the live stream. That would be a good idea as a
that
skater.
Would be cheating, surely.
Listen to the
look how good that was.
Yeah,
no nose touch.
No, it was perfect.
You know, no back truck coming anywhere near. It's like, and it's that front foot catch that he's got on those 360 flips that gives him, you know, access to that trick so well.
Yeah, no, he's for sure jumping in a second, chilling.
So, all eyes on the board right now, 88.99, and he's up in second place and chasing at the heels, but doesn't look like he's very happy with that score.
Was it a 90 before?
Maybe that repetition coming in from 360 flip into thing. No, but it wasn't landed earlier.
No.
So, yeah, confusing times. And, I mean, that shows the crowd really paying attention to what's going on as well. They're like, whoa, no.
Sometimes I feel like the crowd knows the rules more than we do.
Yeah, apparently they do from the sound of what they're saying.
I love
Sora Shirai coming in. Trick 3 of 5. Whoa. Oh. Okay. Caballero backtail, big spin out. Yeah?
What if he does gnarly big spin backtail, big spin on the hubba? Sorry, I'm just daydreaming over here.
Yeah, you're just like setting up. Hey, tune in. This is what Manny wants you to do. Apparently, your trick calling is exactly what people need to do, though. And someone who definitely needs to get some tricks on the board is Aurelio Giraud.
That's probably the most he's missed that trick probably.
Ever.
Yeah, since he mastered it, that's probably the most he's ever missed it.
And the pressure is really on now for Aurelien because he's only got 2 attempts. And it'll be interesting to see whether he steps away from that trick and comes back to it. Because I think at this point he needs to.
Yeah, 100%.
So we're going to take it back to the top of the heat and where we started. Trick 4 of 5. 2 more attempts for each skater to change their position or extend their lead.
Yeah.
So that's where we're at the moment. 95.45 is needed for second. That shows how big Cordano is. Yeah, most people would have come into trouble landing with both legs either side of the rail. He just stepped away from it and walked off like it was nothing.
Yeah, he's 230.
Yeah, I heard yesterday that he has an extra ply on his board.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Sheesh. Bro, he's 230, no fat. He's just straight
he's
muscle.
Absolute beast. But that I mean, you can see that pop that he's got. It's there.
He's super athletic. And he graduated college, all good grades. He's a good kid, man. Good family, good kid. Amazing. Oh, Kelvin doing what Kelvin does. Look, he takes his time, he preps his board.
Oh, yeah, he's not rushing. He's like, we're on Kelvin time now.
Oh, yeah, watch. He's going to show you why.
At this point, the only person that can beat Nyjah, I believe.
It's Kelvin.
It's Kelvin.
It's only Kelvin.
So,
because of his run score.
He's going to know that as well. So, is that pressure on these last two tricks going to, you know, he's a consummate professional when it comes to competition skateboarding.
Wow.
No, it's not affecting him at all.
No. That secured second place for sure.
Yeah.
He can't. So right now the battle for first place is between Kelvin and Nyjah.
Yeah. And
that concreted the second place for either or.
Yeah, maybe Kelvin's just rented a room in Nyjah's head.
Oh, man.
Saying, hey, I'm knocking on the door. Let me in.
If he does have cap nose,
I'm coming for you.
If he does have cap nose back tail on this gap tail, oh, no.
82.95. He's looking confused.
No, it won't be. He's going to have to get a 96, I think.
So
a 96 in order to...
Two lower 80s. It's going to be tough to jump up, but if anyone can, Kelvin can. 259.28 on the board.
Yeah, he needs a 96.15. So he's got to do the half cap nose back tail big spin.
You're calling them out. Going back to... Oh, so, so close. Switch, flip, nose grind.
Sorry, he has one more.
Yep, one more.
Switch for the tail 270. He could jump in his third. I've just skated with these guys for so much of my life.
That's great to hear. You know everyone so well, and you know what people have got in their back pocket. Yeah. But you also, I want to see it.
Yeah, I'm a fan too. I love skateboarding, man.
Okay, Jagger.
Jagger
Boom.
Swagger.
Okay,
was
there
that
it is.
Swagger?
I think we're going to see it. He's going to be stoked to get that out of the way. And to be honest, having not made that three times, to just come back the fourth time, that's that confidence.
Yeah, and do it like nothing. Watch. Look at the way he lands. He goes, look how he landed. You
arms
see that?
Down by his side. I think he was checking something in his pocket.
He went to change the song.
Yeah.
Double tap, change the song.
Boom, getting the nod there from Nyjah.
Yeah, but you see, he didn't really look at him. That's what he does. Nyjah plays mind games on the court, so you know.
91.09 coming through. There's the Jagger swagger we wanted to
see. You see it?
Yeah, there it is.
Oh, yeah. He's all, mm-hmm.
Okay. Current leader. Way up there on that 272.47. Nyjah Huston, trick 4 or 5. Oh, my goodness.
Did his hands hit the ground?
I'm not sure if they did. Is that going to affect it that much to ride away that well? I don't know. I mean, he could look up to the judges and say, hey, I'm calling it. I could do it better. Yeah. But that would be a risky move right now.
Yeah. He didn't.
No. Kept him away. It was like, that floor's electric. I'm not touching it.
That's how he landed last year. And his hat came off.
Hats off
to him.
Can
we get an instant replay of last year's attempt, please? Thank you. Production.
That's a call too far. Okay, waiting for trick 4 of 5 to come through. He's already out there in the lead, and he's just trying to push gap away from Kelvin Hoffler further and further.
No, he pushed it. That's it. Yeah.
93.96. He's stoked with that.
Yeah, that's a
boom. Win. And dropping an 89.92. Wow.
Wow. Yeah, that's something else.
Okay, currently third. Got a 90.22 and an 88.99 on the board. 256.43. Gustavo Ribeiro dropping in. Crooked grind.
Oh.
Whoa, going nollie flip into the board slide. Now the pressure is really on. Last attempt for him. Be interested to see if he plays this safe and just tries to maybe jump up ahead of Kelvin.
Yeah, because all he needs, well, not all he needs, but he needs a 91 point.
Yeah, but he's got a 91.
Yeah, he's got
easily
that.
Got a 91. Yeah. I mean, we didn't see it in the run section. You know, is the 360 flip nosebone slide biggie out on that square rail? Is that going to be up there?
The nollie flip would be.
The nollie flip certainly would be.
Yeah.
But that's high risk. Okay.
Fourth. Sora can get in second.
Whoa!
Sora just jumped in
there
the second.
There we go.
Sora just jumped in the second place.
Incredible skateboarding from Team Japan. And someone at the forefront of that skateboarding is Sora Shirai right now.
Wow.
Boom. The crowd, they are really, really stoked to see this kind of skateboarding going on. So, cab, backside, tail side, big spin. Perfect.
Wow.
Absolutely perfect. And he's got the big spin dialed, absolutely dialed. And you've got to, you know.
Wow.
Wow.
He just jumped into second place. For sure. And if he would have landed his run, a good run, like a mid-80, he could have gave.
93.16. Now Kelvin is going to be saying, I thought I had it.
And Gustavo still has another attempt.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, man, it's getting real spicy.
This is getting crazy out here. Absolutely crazy.
You can't even think of a word. That's how crazy it's getting.
Yeah. Okay, Aurelien Giraud. Oh, wow. Backside 360 kickflip, but over the hover. That, you need that pop. You've got to have that pop. But with four scores in this section, not on the board, looks like he's going to be remaining down there in that eighth place position. Okay, we are taking it back to the top of the heat. This is fifth and final tricks. And it's shaping up to be just spine-tingling. It's so, so gnarly out there. The crowd is really, really screaming for each and every one of these skaters out here. Cordano has one last attempt to change up his position. He's trying to get further and further up that leader list. Wow, going fakie, flip, backside 50-50.
Wow, what an amazing showing for his first event.
Yeah, and I mean, this is the first time he's come out and he gets through to finals. So much more to come from him.
Yeah. What an amazing first event.
So 2-4-1 will be that score he ends on. And we're taking it back round to current third place position, but only because Sora landed that last trick. 259.28 on the board.
Come on,
he can do it.
He could be, if he's smart, if he's, not that he's not smart, I mean, like, if he's smart right now, he doesn't try to go for nothing too insane.
Yeah, 87.04 for second. I mean, he's certainly got a late 80s trick.
Yeah, he's got to do something. He's got to do the half cab nose back tail.
Yeah.
And he's got to go a little slower than he did last time.
But the thing is, when that pressure's on, you can make bad decisions.
Yeah.
But someone as professional as he is, he'll be giving it absolutely everything on this one.
Yeah, he won't.
He knows the importance of it. And to upgrade from finishing in that third place to second, there's a lot of points on the line for that Paris 2024 Olympics.
The build up, let's go.
Bit of a classic maneuver there.
Yeah, that's the original one to do that is Nyjah.
Yeah.
And now Kelvin, he's just on Kelvin time.
So coming in fakie.
Oh, you hate to see it.
You know what's gnarly is the gap out, and then there's not much time.
Yeah,
you're going to land nose slide and pop it around straight away.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And there's a gap at the bottom, too, that people don't see. You don't feel it because you're flying over the hover, but physically there is a gap at the bottom as well.
Yeah, you can see that in that shot. Yep. The hover ends
shorter
on the second step up. So there's a little gap out there. It is short, but there's the gap there, and it's such a mind like game going towards that thing. I would love to see Felipe put this down. Do you think he's going to go back to it? He's in the right position for it.
If he does switch, I can't even look. Oh man, this is too good.
Here we go, coming in switch. flip. Whoa! That was just for you because you asked for it.
But guess what? He'll jump up. Yeah. Regardless, he jumps up, and that's points. But guess what?
It's not going to be enough for third.
But guess what, though? Gustavo still has another try.
Yeah. Hanging in there.
That was so...
Look at that. Stamping it down.
I'm making sound effects. Error. Slow-mo. Error. Wow.
Wow. Okay. Waiting for that fifth and final trick to come through.
I hope they give him the right score, man. Jump that boy up. Give him that 90. Give him a 90.
It's got to be up there, yeah. 90.42. And like you say, he's jumped up. Fifth place, knocking Giordano down.
Yeah, points. We call that points, and we do this little handshake.
254.05.
Like on the course, you go points.
Okay, 90.09 with a 68.96. Looks like he's coming in for the switchback. Noseblunt. Wow, there you go. There's that familiar fist pump.
You're trying to bump Giordano down. That's what it is.
Yeah, certainly. I mean, switchback noseblunt. Yeah. I can't believe we're calling that in a competition.
Yeah, chilling. Gap to Hubba.
Gap to Hubba as well.
He's telling Giordano, he's like, you're my little bro. Don't forget. You're my big little bro. Let me jump up on the list here real quick for you.
Yeah. Sorry, buddy.
Sheesh.
Okay.
Another one that if he would have done a good run.
90.89, and he has bumped him down a bit, finishing on that 250.94.
Wow.
All the power in the final hour there. As we take it back round for fifth and final trick for Nyjah Huston.
He loves this. This is what he does. His victory trick. He
you can see the smirk on his face that he's like, yeah, here we go. Yeah. Going nollie, heel flip, nose grind. And running away from that amazing skateboarding from Nyjah Huston. Coming back stronger than he was before, I believe. And it's that confidence, trick selection, and just being that good at skateboarding.
Yep. Straight up. Straight up.
So final three skateboarders left. Gustavo Ribeiro, 90.22, 88.99, but 77.22. We said it before, if you don't get that higher score on the run section, you're going to really have to rely on the trick section, and this is fifth and final trick for him. Oh. Wow, you could see full commitment on that one. And he's given a wave to the crowd that have been screaming for him all week. Wow. That is going to be it for Gustavo Ribeiro from Portugal.
All right, Mendes Sora.
So, Sora Shirai currently in that second place position. What he's going to be doing is trying to build that gap. He can't improve anymore, but do you in this moment,
do you go crazy or do you just do something fun?
Yeah, go crazy. Do it. Just do it. I mean, how can you deny the crowd?
Facts. Here you go. For the crowd. Oh, he was going full 360. Wow, what a finals.
Yeah. So, he's now got to sit there and see what's coming up from Aurelien, our last rider of the competition, qualified through in first place. The Frenchman has been struggling with those tricks today, starting over that side of the course. Loves to get a bit of speed. Tried that backside 360 kickflip. This one's for the crowd right now and for himself. Wow, getting it on the feet, spinning it around, but saying thank you very much. No scores in this section. I think getting that low score in the run really knocked his confidence. Yeah. And he just couldn't pull it together and get those tricks down.
Yeah.
But wow. What a final, mate. What a final. I'm exhausted.
Oh, my letter.
So here are our results. We had eighth place Aurelien. Giordano hanging in there. Jagger eating, just pipping him to that one. Felipe jumping back in at the end. And then fourth place for Gustavo. Top three, Kelvin Hoffler, Sora Shirai, and 276.51 points for your winner, Nyjah Huston.
Wow.
And
absolutely great final. We're going to chuck it down to Sam
now. It's your first win after coming back after injury. Can you talk us through it?
Yeah, last year went well. A couple months later, I was street skating, tore the ACL. You know, that was a hard comeback because that was my first serious injury ever. And I definitely didn't picture I would be in this position right now. But, you know, it was a ton of hard work. And I've been hungry for a win, so we got one. USA, let's go.
And obviously you dominated from the start. You know, loads of people were hot on your tail. Do you think you got in their heads a little bit?
A little bit, and also it's just a momentum thing. Like, you get a first good rundown, it really helps you carry that momentum through the rest of the contest. So I was feeling confident out there. We made it happen.
And so can you tell us what's happening next then? What's lining up for you?
What's next? Let's see. We're going back home. Going to do some street skating. Like, I'm always in the streets. And then we got 4th of July. I actually missed last 4th of July because I was here and then I had to fly to London for a shoot. So big 4th of July celebration this year. Let's go.
Awesome. Thank you so much and good luck with the rest of it.
Thank you.
Yeah, definitely going to be celebrating 4th of July in style after taking this win here out in Rome. Our wow. Top three right now. Let's check out those runs. Kelvin Hoffler, kickflip nose grind. 360 flip lip. Kelvin, so sturdy on his board and really put on a good show today.
That face.
And we saw that half cab, backside Smith. 180 out. And then that was just so good to see. And you knew that he needed it at that point.
100%.
But it just wasn't enough. And Sora Shirai coming through right at the end and getting that second place. There's the Sora grind.
Sorda grind. Wow.
Look at the focus then dropping in. Like, yeah, this nice. Is coming home with me right
yes,
now.
Sir. Nine.
Boom.
D.
There it is.
Shiduri.
And then we saw it right wow. there. That sealed the deal. Caballero backside tail slide. Big spin out. And here is our winner, USA's Nyjah Huston. Really, really showing the shape of things to come as we move forward through our world tour. Nyjah Huston looking so comfortable out there. There it was. Switch heel flip tail slide. Man. What a crazy
I'm
trick.
I'm telling you, they got to go back and watch. He did the exact same thing. He landed the same exact way as last time. They got to do it side by side on Instagram.
Okay, our next event will be Lausanne. And we can't wait to see you there 9th to the 16th of September for yes, Street. Sure. Manny,
that's my birthday.
I want to be calling your tricks.
Yes, it'll be my birthday.
Well, there you go. What a better way to celebrate
September
your birthday
10th.
Than going
yes,
skating.
Sir. Yes, sir. Be with all my friends. Joe Rogan, brother!
Thank you so much for joining me, mate. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Yes,
you're a total legend. And you've really made my job easy by being so good today. And thank you very much to each and every one of you for joining us live out here in Rome. We'll see you in Lausanne next. It's going to be a banger, and it's been a pleasure to take you through the second event of our season. We'll see you at the next one.
Later.
Stay winning, finna get the belt. Then I'm finna get the wealth. Show me the money, cause ain't nobody else. Done it like this, want it this quick. Get in the booth and press up on a hit stick. Oh, she got me on a wish list. Hit it once and I dip quick. Like I'm running from the cops. Now I'm dipping from the dots. They want it on top of the yacht. And back on the low on a cot. You gotta know that I'm a boss. High stakes, all cost. Steady paying what I'm seeing, getting paid for it like I'm Bob Ross. Hold up now, call up now. Show up now, finna blow now. Pull up now, blow up now. Grow up ready for my toes up now. Throw up now, don't slow it down. Been the only one to really hold it down. And the city thinking I'm a pro now. Y'all owe it now. Look. Just know it.